If you come and apply for the job as a sports sales representative on WQAM, you too can enjoy fabulous in-depth meetings every Monday morning. When Luann, the sales manager, like, throws stuff at you because you're not up to your quota. She throws food at people. I saw her do that.
First you did?
Who'd she throw it at?
Can I get a name?
We'll do that tomorrow morning.
Okay.
We'll go in-depth because in-depth tomorrow, can apply, and we will name names. We will throw people under the bus.
Hey, they're not here anymore. That's why we need a new salesperson.
This is true, too. Creeper and Zach, another great job. Goldie, you folks. Josh Beckett, thanks to you, too. Have a nice day in paradise, everybody, on QAM.
Thanks for the food, Mo. This is South Florida's only real sports station. WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale. A Beasley Podcast Corporation. And WQAM.com. World.
Thanks to Mo and Kelly for the food from Corky, which is really for us anyway, right now. And Muff thinks that Hank wanted
very
better than sex.
I like Dick a lot.
She gained acclaim with her breakout performance in The People vs. Larry Flint. Now, Courtney Love takes the theater by storm, appearing in the classics at the Seattle Repertory Playhouse. See her riveting performance as Lady Macbeth in The Scottish Play.
Is this the mother dagger I see before me?
As Blanche DuBois in A Streetcar Named Desire.
I've always relied on the kindness of strangers.
Sucker!
And of course, St. Joan by George Bernard Shaw.
Get that torch away from me, you mother... sucking bastards!
Yes, Courtney Love plays the classics this spring at the Seattle Repertory Playhouse.
Yeah. Get out of my face.
Order your tickets today.
Son of a mother.
Hey, she can't help it. She's got a potty mouth, okay? That's what she said. That's what she blamed for her arrest over there in London yesterday. She's got a potty mouth and she can't help it. If you're noticing right off the bat that we're not doing the noon to 1 hour and the 9 to 10 hour, Schmidt can't, that idea. Bad idea. George liked it. Nobody
else liked it.
I don't care. You got your free food. Shut up.
Thanks, Howard.
Although we didn't get the brisket. Thanks, Mo and Geldy, for the free food from Corky's, even though it was for us. See, evidently what happened is somebody heard me begging and then you chiming in and begging and begging and pleading, almost even worse than Rimmer, for free food. We'll tell you the Rimmer story in a little bit, by the way, about Pizza Loft. But anyway, and they told them that it was for the guys on a morning show. So they sent a note with the food for Howard, David, and Steve Goldstein from our friend, your friends at Corky's. Well, it wasn't for them at all. They didn't even know what that was all about. Now, Geldy was nice enough to come in here and say, whatever he said, you know. I saw Mo in the hallway, and he didn't say anything about the food. Didn't thank me, didn't bond, didn't ask how I was feeling. In fact, I think it was a plot. You notice, because there wasn't any brisket. It was potato pancakes, it was potato latkes, and French toast chunks, which I've never seen that before in my life, and man, that was good.
Yeah, they were.
How do you describe that? They're like chunks of bread.
They didn't even need syrup or anything.
No.
Just,
no, because they're already sweet.
Like
they're pure, like bread and sugar, pure
up,
carbohydrate, which I'm like, really? Oh, man.
Sprinkled lightly with powdered sugar.
Oh. So, and I came in this morning. My blood sugar was great. This is going to be the new deal. Well, the 9 to 10 hour will be, what ailment does Neil have this morning? That's going to be it. Yesterday it was those stogies. Man, those things are killers. Those little cherry stogies. No more of those, Derek. Okay? No more of that crap. Oh, thought we had our first call of the day there. WQAM.
Glad to speak to Neil.
I beg your pardon?
Glad to speak to Neil.
Where are you calling from?
95.
Okay, let's go to a call on I-95. Hello.
Neil?
Yes, sir. Yes?
Is this Neil?
Yes, it is.
Neil, Pigler, corner of a commercial and power line. picking your nose and biting your nail. Then if you take your finger.
Okay, thanks for the alert.
You're welcome.
Okay. Chew very slowly, by the way. I got a better story on that thing in San Francisco about the marijuana trial. I got a better story than the one I had. Thank you, whoever faxed that. We'll get to it. Now, that whole business about the 9 to 10 hour, we can't capitulate to that. We're just going to have to do our 4-hour show. We can't, like, start and stop. It just doesn't work. That was a bad idea, George. No, actually, it was Carlos's idea, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was,
his.
You know, just because you've been here for a couple of months and got a couple of paychecks, don't start playing program director. We got enough program directors already, more than we can count. So don't start playing butch boss. Oh, yeah, I think you guys ought to like... But out. Here's the poll result from yesterday. See, if they want to hear the show, they got to tune in at 9. If they have other things, if they're dawdling in other places, well, to them, okay? When they get here, they'll get here. It's like coming into in a movie in the middle of the movie. What's the point? Huh? Like turning on Smallville last night in the middle
halfway
of the show.
Through, yeah, who
well, I'm
do
sorry.
That?
Idiot. George missed half of Smallville last night. He's out. You're out. It was a good show. That was the best Smallville ever, I think.
Bad Clark is always good.
Bad Clark is always good. He had that red, socket rocket in his pocket or something like that. And boy, he just was going apeshit. And then all of a sudden, damn it, that thing fell out. Just about when she was about to unbuckle his pants, too. Chloe.
Wouldn't you know it?
Yeah. Wouldn't you know it, Chloe? Bitch. And luckily, she lost all her mammary. Of course, Lana, she lost her mammary at birth because she didn't have any.
No.
She's got, like, little raisinettes in spite of what you say. I still say Chloe's hotter than she is,
had big
but
boobs.
Who really gives a crap?
I never said she had big boobs, Lana.
You said she had some. I think that Lex Luthor's got bigger knots on his forehead than she's got on her chest. But at any rate, it was a good
bump
episode.
On the back of his head.
And I don't have my poster from the Sun Sentinel. I must have thrown it out with the Brandsmart section.
Damn it.
Huh? Well, they showed last night what it looked like, and everybody had all their clothes on, so who the hell needs that? We're not interested in if the people got their clothes on. We asked yesterday, which of these people are you most convinced is gay or bisexual? The usual stellar response, 1,282 votes. Now, guess who didn't get any? This may come as a tremendous shock to you.
All right.
Jeff Goldblum.
Yeah, I don't get that either.
I don't think they know who that is. He was in The Fly. Anybody remember The Fly? Of course not.
He's annoying. I never thought he was
gay. He is very annoying and very, like, Jewy looking. You know what I mean?
Well.
Shepard Smith from MSNBC. Shepard Smith, he didn't get any. And I don't think necessarily that I ever thought that he was gay. Just strange. He's an alien. Like, what's his name? The dark kid was saying on Smallville last night, screaming at Clark, he's an alien, he's an alien. He was screaming that.
Yeah.
He's out of this world. Shepard Smith, who's an alien on MSNBC, he didn't get any. And Daniel Gay Lewis didn't get any. Now, going back up on top. Guess who won, Carlos? Guess who won by a landslide? Who these people out there think are most convinced is gay or bi?
Jorge.
I'll give you 5,000 guesses who it is.
Hello, George.
George Rodriguez, 220 votes. Let's hear it for George.
I'm still not going to go.
You've got good company, though.
I know.
Dennis, the chronic caller slash Catholic champion. Chronic Dennis. They think you're a gay, Dennis.
He has a wife.
Because like I've told him many, many times, nobody is that hysterical, that homophobic. That, of course, it's kind of that Catholic Church priest cover-up thing, you know.
No, I think he's a level unto himself with that.
Is he? 118 votes for Dennis, the chronic. Tom Cruise, 105. Who's holding another press conference in about 5 minutes to tell you that he's not gay. See, I hate to break the news to all you entertainers out there, but when you hold press conferences and when you file lawsuits, by the way, nice going, Leona Helmsley.
Oh!
11 million for that queen. Tom Cruise had 105. Prince had 90. Ricky Martin, who was the late addition, and I have no idea why, it was Carlos's fault, he had 57. Troy Aikman, Troy the Boy, had 50. Janet Reno, 49. She was right on Troy's ass. And Jeff Garcia, who was also a little bit of a late addition. Jeff Garcia, he is just strange. 49. Little Brian Norcross had 42. Merv Griffin, 35. Hillary Clinton, 33. Bill Kamal, who gets beat out by Brian Norcross, who's obviously still the official weather fairy. But Miss Kamal, who's weather fairy junior, had 31. Jodie Foster, 31. You don't think she's a dyke, do you? Did I say Jeff Gordon, 28? Mike Piazza, 28. Mayor Alex Pinga Pequeña, 25. Nice going, Alex. Justin from American Idol. What's his name? Justin, Grimes. Justin, Grimey Justin. I don't know what it is. We don't care. He's really also bizarre. Oh, and guess who's going to be on Smallville next week?
I give up.
I don't know what his name. Kid used to play on Guiding Light.
Oh. I have no idea.
Well, isn't that important? Brian Andrews. Little Brian Andrews had 20 votes over there at Channel 7 News. He, flitting around over there. Justin Tinkerbell had 16. Matt Damon, 16. Oh, Matt Damon should be a lot higher than that. I'm convinced now.
He's another alien.
He's in a new movie. Why is it that every movie he was in, he plays some fag? Why is that?
Coincidence.
Okay. Barry Manilow, 15. Ricky Williams, 15. That's bad. I'm going to complain to Dolphin Management about that. That Ricky Williams is a better butch up a little bit, just because he ran for 2,000 yards damn near. Puff Diddy Daddy, he had 14. Richard Gere, 14. From American Gerbilo. Cordell Stewart, 12. A lot of football players on here, huh? Paul Schaefer from David Letterman, even though he's got a wife and 14 kids, we don't care. We still believe it. 12. You do. Ari Fleischer, 10. Enrique Iglesias had 10. Remember Enrique? Yeah, him. Kevin Spacey, 10. Steve Young, 9. Another football player. Damn it! Ben Affleck, 8. He's holding a press conference right after Tom gets through. In fact, what they're going to do now is they're going to have press conferences with guys lined up. I'm not gay. And then they'll say, I'm not either. Me either. Nope, not me. I'll just save a lot of time. Leo DiCaprio had only 7. J-Lo, 7 votes. They think she's a dyke. Wait till you hear who got six. Tied with Keanu Reeves is Kimba Bocamper.
It's the name.
You know, the dead giveaway was when it came on here last weekend and said, "Meet Kimba." I think that was the giveaway.
Oh.
Yeah. Don't you think?
No.
Don't do that again, Kim. Always a big guy, and he could beat the crap out of all of us with one hand. Keanu Reeves, 6. George Clooney, 5. Mike Tyson had 5. Wayne Newton, 5. John Travolta, 5. Jimmy Syphilis had 5. Hey, butch up, Jimmy. Remember when Jimmy said, I don't want to go into it, when he was supposed to get married the first time and, like, on his wedding day changed his mind, like, the whole thing? And Tony Cigaretto said, well, That's what he said. Well, yeah, he knew something, but he wasn't saying. Arsenio Hall and Eddie Murphy each have 4 and Winona Ryder as well. Kenny G have 3. I mean, is it really worth going all the way down the list here?
Gee.
Lance Bass, 3. Paul Stanley from Kiss, 3. Henry Winkler, Robbie Alomar, 3. Another jock. Missy Misdemeanor Elliott, all of these had 2, okay? Missy Misdemeanor Elliott, 2. Don Francisco, 2. From Que Pasa USA, Sabado Gigante. Well, I like Que Pasa USA better. Much better show.
Oh, no question.
How you doing, Rocky? Echevarria? Stevie? Tommy Selleck, 2. Elijah Wood had a pair. And Mike Myers had 2. And with one apiece, the wonderful John Tesh. Let's hear the pianist stylings of John Tesh. Jeff Goldblum had 1. Burt Reynolds had 1, who's also holding a press conference. Dave Damien, the Channel 10 weather guy, which I have no idea. I only know Don...
Boy!
Don...
No.
Oh, see, I haven't used that in a long time. Don, no. Do you know who Dave Damien is? No.
No.
Tobey Maguire and Sinbad and Scott Wolf had 1. Yanni and Matthew Broderick had 1. Scott Wolf only had 1, and you want to know why? Because they don't know who that is.
Who?
Party of 5. Party in your pants, 5. Scott Wolf, who floats like a butterfly and stings like a queen bee. It's 11 after 9 at 560 WQM, so that was kind of like for fun, you know, just for fun. Just for fun, unlike, of course, that bitch, that nasty, miserable bitch that got sued for $11 million. Yeah, I think that's WQM. Guys, what women really wanted Valentine's Day is for you to put a little thought and creativity into your gift. This year, express yourself in a fun and original way and say it with a Vermont teddy bear. Just call 1-800-829-BEAR, and a friendly bear counselor will help you pick from over 100 bears, handcrafted in Vermont and delivered in a colorful gift box with a free card and chocolate. Tell her she lights your fire with a new Burn Love Bear dressed like a hunky fireman with a love tattoo on his arm. Or say, I'm wild about you with a Jungle Love Bear. They have an N officially licensed. What is it? Oh, you know what? They do the word processor, and they don't retype these.
Or read them.
Proofread. Or read them, or
spell
anything like
check
that.
Or anything.
Well, I'm going to tell you, Adam, we thought that you were a real guy, but you're just another sales hole. They have an officially licensed Love Me Tender Elvis Bear. Sending a Vermont teddy bear is creative and personal alternative to flowers, and it'll be around long after Valentine's Day to remind you of her of you. Send her, this is the worst. Send her a bear to the office so that her coworkers can see just how thoughtful and romantic you're pretending to be. Overnight and Valentine's Day delivery is guaranteed, too. Call 1-800-829-BEAR. By the way, they love us at Vermont Teddy Bear, and we want to make sure that they understand it's not me. It's really bad copy. Blame it on Adam, okay? Give it to an AE as soon as we hire one. Give it to somebody who knows what they're doing. Call 1-800-829-BEAR or shop online at VermontTeddyBear.com. This year for Valentine's Day, say it with a Vermont teddy bear. Tell them that Neil told you to call 1-800-829-BEAR and tell them that Adam in sales,
he's an asshole.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Take off those checkered pants.
Thank you for calling. This is T. Tony. How may I help you?
I just picked up my 92 Accord from your lot, and there is a huge turd in the back seat.
A huge turd?
Yes.
And there's what in the back seat?
A turd. A piece of a big-ass human turd in the back seat of my car.
Ma'am, I assure you, our guys did not take a dump in your car. If you want to, bring that car back, and we'll take a look at it.
You want to take a look at it? My car is fine. It's that big-ass turd in the back seat.
Okay, what would you like me to do?
I said, okay, how about I go to your house and pitch a loaf on your couch?
Ma'am,
how about that?
Ma'am, what would you like me to do to fix the situation?
I want somebody to come over here, get this turd out my back seat.
That's not going to happen.
Car. What do you mean it's not going to happen?
You can bring the car here and we can take a look at it.
I am. I'm going to bring it back there. You know what I'm going to do?
Huh.
I'm going to take a dump in every last car you got there. I'm going to pee on your counter. I'm going to do it all.
Okay.
Show you how it feels.
Okay.
And you know what? You sound like a big burly man. It probably came out your ass.
Oh, yeah. I don't make it a habit of going out and taking a dump in the car.
How much do you weigh?
About 400 pounds.
That's your turd. That's
my turd, huh?
Yes.
That came up from a 400-pound man,
this
huh?
This is a 400-pound man, either that or a gorilla.
Okay.
I'm driving this car right to my lawyer's office, and I'm going to let the whole world see. You're going to be on the news this evening, buddy. I'm going to get seven on my side. Watch. You're going to be on the news.
Can you describe the piece of shit? I mean, what does it look like?
You know what it is. It came out your ass. What the hell? What kind of... Asking me what color. I tell you what, it smells ungodly. That's what it smells like. Smells like you sold your ass to the devil. That came from the pits of hell.
Well, how big is it? How long is it?
It's not as long as my arm. I don't think it's fun. Why y'all, this is not fun. I got a damn 2x4 in my back seat. You know, I think this some racial shit too. That's what this is. Little kids are running away from it.
Oh my.
I'm glad y'all find this funny.
Okay.
You're probably on the steering wheel too, don't you?
All right. How long does it look like it's been sitting there?
Steam is coming off of it, okay?
Steam is coming off of it?
Yes. It's a fresh turd.
Okay. What you need to do is you need to bring that turd back, and we'll match it up. We got a lineup. We'll match it up with the other turds that we have.
Well, what you need to do is learn how to use a toilet.
You say you're not going to bring the turd back to me?
No. You know what?
Is this a sample?
No. I'm starting to like it.
You're going to keep it as a fact?
I'm going to keep it. Because it's a nice, you know what? It's a nice conversation piece.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Hey, thanks, man.
Oh, thank you, brother.
Then you're welcome. Okay, 20 after 9 at 560 WQM. Here's one. It said, double check your paper for the poster, the Smallville poster. No, thanks. It's folded up to about the size of a trade paperback book, easy to miss. Also, it says it was a good episode until the end. I can't see these two thrill seekers wearing their seatbelts, so why didn't they come crashing through the windshield when he caught the car? There's nothing like watching a show like Smallville, where all these superhuman, outer space, alien-oriented stuff are going on, and worrying about whether they were in their seatbelts and why they didn't come. Let's start analyzing each scene. Lighten up just a little bit. Also, I was thinking he chased the car off the cliff and pushed it across, leaving him wondering if he really can fly. But like he told his dark-complected friend and Chloe there, he ain't no comic book character, okay? He can't fly. You got it? Here's our poll today, and of course we got the Secretary of State, the illustrious Colin Powell. Going to be speaking to the UN today, starting at about 10:30. Are we going to be carrying that?
No.
Because they said he's going to speak for 90 minutes. Do you think we ought to carry that? No. We'll carry, excerpts, you know, like every now and then when it looks like he might be saying something important, like, we don't have a smoking gun, but we know they've done it. The whole thing, basically what it boils down to is double negatives. In other words, like us saying, well, we don't believe in God, and you saying to me, prove there's no God.
Aha!
See? I'm sure that there's a whole bunch of drugs in there in that room of yours in there. Positive. Isn't there?
I wish.
No, prove there's not. Prove it's not there. So that's basically what it's all about. So we'll have like little excerpts like...
For the security.
There, like that. Here's today's poll. What's your take on the war with Iraq? Several categories as usual to give you an opportunity to like fumble around all over the place. We've got six categories. All for it. Let's roll. I support it, but I'm nervous about it. Have not been convinced it's justified. I'm strongly against it. Let's take care of North Korea first, or don't know. And of course, anybody who said don't know, like that, I worry about those people. But every poll that's taken, like is it Wednesday or Thursday? Don't know. Not sure. Yeah. There's always at least 1 or 2% who aren't sure of anything. And of course, those are in our audience. What's your take on the war with Iraq? All for it. Let's roll. I support it, but I'm nervous about it. Haven't been convinced it's justified. I'm strongly against it. Let's take care of North Korea first, or don't know. And by the way, speaking of those people who are strongly against it, there are all these war protests, these anti-war protests going on, not just here in town, but all over America, all over the world. And yet, for some strange reason, your media can't seem to discover them. They can't find them.
Right.
Your local newscast, when we have one like we had yesterday, can't find it. Don't have time to talk about it.
Now, if three... aliens of any ilk gather at an intersection.
You mean like the Raelians?
Right.
Well, then it's the lead story on the news. By the way, anybody heard about the Raelians lately?
No.
No. Anybody seen those babies, those cloned babies?
No.
Nope. Anybody believe it?
No.
Nope.
Won't see them no more.
Yeah.
Well, oh, sure you will. They'll pop up again.
During the Elyon stuff and all that, three green teeth gathered at an intersection. It's a rally! It's a rally!
Right, that's right.
But a war protest with
right.
Blocking
and
traffic.
And it was out about the INS building. Don't you
right.
They have like, oh, major protest, and they showed the thing on the camera. There's like six people there.
Right.
Three of whom were just lined up to get their visa or whatever, you know, a MasterCard. Oh, brother. I'm telling you, you people in the media, you're crazy people. Like that. That's why nobody believes you anymore. That's why more and more people are searching. That's why more people ought to go to our website, even if they don't want to vote
right.
on our stupid poll every day, which is just for fun, and read some of the good bedtime stories we got on there. It's damn good stuff, which I just don't want to take the time to be ponderous and read all that crap on the air here, because that's not what our audience wants. Our audience wants... Exactly. Very good. That's exactly what they want. A lot of that. A lot of heavy-duty farts. Right? Farts
all
and
day
burps
long.
And yucks and stuff like that. And turds like the one she found in her back seat.
Steaming.
Oh, I guess it was a foot long. But at any rate, Courtney Love blames potty mouth for arrest. You bitch, you slut, you whatever you are. Courtney Love has blamed her bad language for the alleged air rage incident that led to arrest at London's Heathrow Airport yesterday. As she left Heathrow's police station, Love said, I cussed at a lady. My daughter always said I had a potty mouth. No. Love, former lead singer of the band Hole and widow of Nirvana star Kurt Cobain, was arrested after accusations of verbally abusing crew members on a flight from L.A. She was later released with a caution for causing harassment, alarm, and distress after 9 hours in custody. When asked what it had been like inside the police station, the singer said, it was fine. They were wonderful in there. It was like being on Prime Suspect. She told reporters the brief verbal disagreement had been highly exaggerated. Love said she had complained that staff didn't let her friend sit in first class with her. When asked how she felt about her treatment at the hands of the airline, the singer said, I've always been flying British Airways for a long time and will continue to do so. It was my second time on Virgin and my first time wasn't so great either. It was the second time she was a Virgin and her first time wasn't too good either. How do you like that? Courtney Love with a big, fat, disgusting potty mouth. Who the hell who cares about her anymore?
No one I know.
I like her to elope with Delene Sion. Delene Skion. Here's a good fax I got from a guy named Mirio. I will not use his last name, although he had the balls to put it on there. I won't use his last name because obviously we care about his safety and the way things are going in America today. You just don't say opinions that are anti-anything. Just don't do it. You don't even think them. It says war is not an option. I didn't vote yet on the poll. Okay, I voted on the poll. He says, if the American people and the world community felt the grief, pain, and sorrow over the hundreds and thousands of children, mothers, fathers, and grandmothers, cousins, ordinary people of Iraq expected to be killed by Bush's war on Saddam Hussein like they have for the seven astronauts, war would not be an option. The Iraqi people are not Saddam Hussein nor the people responsible for the tower attacks. The destruction and death of the American weapons of mass destruction should not be an option for the vast majority of religious, peace-loving, and children-loving Americans. The United States is the number one producer and user of weapons of mass destruction, such as in Hiroshima and the herbicide Agent Orange in South Vietnam, just to name a pair. The chemicals we dumped in Vietnam continues to move through the water and soil. As a result, children continue to be born with defects and many have leukemia. Bush and his administration and silent Americans will have blood on their hands for all the Iraqis and American servicemen and women killed on a pretext for national security. The American people can stop the Bush madness of mass killing in the name of peace and defense of this country. Signed, not a very proud American, Mario, and I won't use his last name because we fear for his safety. How do you like that? Nice going, Mario, having the balls to stand up and even put his name on it. Amen. Got a few votes on there to pull us up. What's your take on the war with Iraq? Strongly against the date. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 5. I support it, but nervous about it, 4. Let's take care of North Korea first, 4. All for it, let's roll, 3. And don't know, 1. There's always got to be one, kind of like that Greg Reed vote.
Yeah.
Yeah, like that. 27 after 9 at 560 WQM. All you guys out there, if you want to make a New Year's resolution to look better and have a real life in 2003, and it's already February, do something about it now. Call my good buddy Charles Alfieri, and if nothing else, get some hair back and look younger and better than you have in a long, long time, and probably better than you ever thought you could again, because Charlie will make it look like you got your real hair back. It's the natural hairline system, the best in the business. He's got the latest technology that allows him to make it look like the hair's really grown out of your scalp instead of like some grotesque, awful, nasty-looking animal died right on top of your head. In fact, I saw somebody in the hallway this morning when I went out there to get the food, and it looked like a whole bunch of animals just were resting there. Just a pit stop. It was the pits. Anyway, Charlie's been helping guys for over 25 years. He can do the same for you at a very reasonable price. And if you mention Neil Rogers when you call, he'll knock $200 off the regular price of the natural hairline system. So the choice is yours. You can do that Propecia, or you can take... You can take and drill a bunch of holes in your head, or you can take a lot of nasty stuff that's not going to do any good anyway. It won't work. But if you really want to look good, get the Natural Hairline System from Chuck Alfieri. Call him toll-free, and in no time at all, you'll look pretty spiffy. Call 1-800-321-2413. That's 1-800-321-2413, or log on to the website, charlesalfieri.com.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Gang rape is funny.
A soap opera like nothing you've seen before.
Excuse me, esteemed father.
What is it, my child?
I have something I must tell you.
What is it, my daughter?
Oh, father, I am afraid to tell you.
Afraid to tell me, your own father?
I fear I will bring shame upon our family.
Nonsense. I am your father. I love you very much. You must tell me what is wrong.
You promise you will still love me?
Of course, my sweet child. A father's love is not erased by a simple misdeed.
Very well. I am... Oh, I am pregnant.
Oh, I see.
Do you still love me, father?
Of course I do. But since you're pregnant and not married...
Yes, father?
I'm afraid I must drag you down to the town square and, with the help of my friends and neighbors, stone you to death. Yes, my daughter, it is written that this is the punishment for what you have done.
Could you check again, father? That I should only be grounded.
No, grounding does not work. I must have you stoned.
It's the first soap opera that focuses on a fundamentalist Middle Eastern family.
May I speak with you, my esteemed husband?
Yes, what is it, my wife?
Oh, I have something to tell you.
I am listening.
I am having an affair.
Oh, I see.
Where are you going?
Oh, out to the backyard to collect some stones.
Oh, do you mean...
Yes, I must drag you to the town square, where you will, of course, be stoned to death.
You'll be mesmerized as you follow the lives of the Ahmed family and how they deal with the many problems that plague them.
Oh, may I speak with you, my esteemed father?
Yes, my son.
Oh, father, last night I used illegal drugs.
Well, what do you know? You are one lucky boy.
Oh, why is that, father?
You are going to get stoned two nights in a row.
You won't want to miss The Guiding Shiite. The Guiding Shiite is shot on location in Baghdad, Iraq.
Guiding Shiite, 933 at 560 WQAM. Launch woes downplayed, workers say. Oh, before we do that. So yesterday, George, of course, between George and Carlos in there, giving us a lot of bum steers, tell us about this big contretemps that was going on next door in Clarence's orifice.
There was yelling.
There was not yelling. They were like having a powwow. They're having a strategy session. They were planning like a bunch of crap in there.
Really loudly then, and all animated.
Well, so what's wrong with that? It's about time they got loud and animated, okay? Maybe somebody might hear them. Well, and of course, guess who called the station, calling everybody who could find in the building, just salivating. Somebody who's like out there like a vulture waiting to hop in here on the carcass. I'll give you a clue.
I dumped the bitch right now.
Joe Rose.
Oh, really?
And I tell you, he's a real yenta. Joe Rose was calling everybody. He's calling even the janitor. What's going on down there? What's going on down there? Is there that morning open again? Is that a, you know, that's what he told him.
I dumped the bitch right now.
Get out of here. Calm down, Joe. We like you a lot, but you're an idiot. Launch woes downplayed, workers say. Engineer damage study flawed. See, I mean, they had the ceremony up there at the Cape yesterday, and we saw all the people crying, and the president and Laura Bush were there, and everybody was duly grief-stricken. But the fact of the matter is basically that this was almost like a suicide mission. Negligence, right. Lack of funding, lack of paying attention to a space shuttle mission managers at a key January 24th meeting hastily approved a technical analysis that some shuttle engineers now say overlooked the fatal potential of debris damage to Columbia. The engineers told the Orlando Sentinel that the analysis presented 8 days after the launch was guided by false assumptions and was colored by the grim realization that nothing could be done to save Columbia's seven astronauts in a worst-case scenario. Other concerns about the severity of the debris strike were also downplayed, according to some shuttle workers. And there's a picture that they've got to show the big dent in the left wing. But for some strange reason, the American networks have all declined to show it. Canadian networks are showing it. It looks like somebody ran their Humvee into the side of your SUV, is what it looks like. A big, big-ass dent. Unlike Challenger, there was no way to prevent this, but the same scenario played out, a Johnson Space Center engineer said. A problem was identified, but by the time it got to management, it was sugar-coated.
Huh.
How about that? Just like the O-rings on the Challenger, remember
right.
that scientist warned them about that days before the launch?
Shut up.
And about if they freeze up and it's too cold and don't you dare, et cetera. Well, they wanted to get it done in time for Reagan's inauguration speech, so let's take a shot, you know?
State of the Union.
What did I call it?
Inauguration.
Well, whatever the hell it was, a State of the Union speech. Well, I forgot what it was.
Sugar in your
if it's
head
good
right
enough
now.
For him, yeah. I got all that potato pancakes and that French toast in my head. I think it's a plot. I think Mo must have, like, planted it out there. In fact, maybe they did call Corky's and have him bring it in.
I dump the bitch right now.
I'm sure you would. I'm sure you would. So anyway, this story about the pot trial in San Francisco, this is so typical of what's going on with your federal government these days, with your goose-stepping government. What's your take on the war with Iraq? Let's take a look at our poll first before we get into the pot story. And this guy who now is facing up to 85 years in jail, and the entire jury says, we were given wrong information. If we'd have known what the consequences were and what the real deal here, we wouldn't have convicted him at all. But we'll get to that. 89 votes, strongly against the war, 29, haven't been convinced it's justified, 19, all for it, let's rule, 16, that's 17.9%. Rounded off to...
Almost there. 18%.
Rounded off to... I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 8, 11. Let's take care of North Korea first, 10. And don't know, no clue,
yeah.
4. In an unusual show of solidarity with the man they convicted last week, 5 jurors in the trial of medicinal marijuana advocate issued a public apology to him yesterday and demanded that the judge grant him a new trial. The jurors said they'd been unaware that the defendant, Ed Rosenthal, was growing marijuana for medicinal purposes, allowed since 1996 under California state law. When they convicted him on 3 federal counts of cultivation and conspiracy, he's to be sentenced in June and faces a minimum of 5 years in prison and up to 85 years. I'm sorry, doesn't begin to cover it, said one of the jurors, Marnie Craig, a property manager in Novato, California. It's the most horrible mistake I've ever made in my entire life, and I don't think that I personally will ever recover from this. The judge in the case, Judge Charles Breyer of Federal District Court, had barred Mr. Rosenthal's defense from mentioning the state law because he was indicted under federal law, which does not allow the growing of marijuana for any purpose. When he was arrested last February, Mr. Rosenthal was cultivating starter plants in a warehouse that were to be distributed to seriously ill patients by medical marijuana clubs in the San Francisco Bay Area. Mr. Rosenthal, who lives in Oakland, was acting in his official capacity as an officer of the city under Oakland's medical marijuana ordinance, Oakland officials said. In a statement read outside the federal courthouse there, the 5 jurors, joined by an alternate, said they would not have voted to convict Mr. Rosenthal if they'd been allowed to consider the California law. The group said they represented the views of at least 2 others who'd served on the 12-member panel. In good faith, we as jury members allowed ourselves to be blindfolded to weigh in the evidence before us, the statement said. But in this trial, the prosecution was allowed to put all of the evidence and testimony on one side of one of the scales, while the defense was not allowed to put its evidence and testimony on the other scale. Therefore, we were not allowed as a jury to properly weigh the case. One by one, the jurors stepped up to a lectern and apologized to Mr. Rosenthal, his wife Jane Klein, and their daughter Justine, who stood nearby. We as a jury were truly kept in the dark, said Charles Sackett of Sebastopol, who was the jury foreman. I never want to see this ever happen again. In a striking demonstration of how deep the divide remains between federal and California laws on medicinal uses of marijuana, the jurors were joined by the San Francisco District Attorney and 2 members of the San Francisco Board of Supervisors. 8 other states allow the sick and dying to smoke or grow marijuana with doctor's recommendation. This really is a travesty, Matt Gonzalez, the board's president, said of the court's decision to exclude the state law from Mr. Rosenthal's defense. The jurors have been violated by this court, Mr. Gonzalez said. Before holding the news conference, the jurors attended a hearing during which the U.S. Attorney's Office asked that Mr. Rosenthal's bail be revoked. Let me say it again. The U.S. Attorney's Office asked that Mr. Rosenthal's bail be revoked. Judge Breyer ruled, however, that Mr. Rosenthal was not likely to flee and let him remain free on $200,000 bond pending his sentencing. Though none of the jurors made their feelings known to the judge at the hearing, where 5 of them and the alternate sat in the front of the courtroom, Mr. Sackett said he was there, certain their presence helped persuade the judge to allow Mr. Rosenthal to remain free. We didn't say a word, Mr. Sackett said. We're not disrespectful. We just wanted to make a statement. Mr. Rosenthal's lawyer said they'd filed a motion to have the indictment against Mr. Rosenthal dismissed. If that fails, they said they'll file a motion for a new trial. If that should also fail, the lawyer said they'll appeal the verdict to the United States Court of Appeals. How do you like that? But the U.S. Attorney's Office has Mr. Rosenthal's bail be revoked because he's a dangerous and hardened criminal.
Right on.
A seed planter. A pot grower. for medicinal purposes only, which is allowed under California
law.
Sure,
that's what he says.
But don't bother telling that to the jury, because the federal government wants to put everybody's ass in jail, ladies and gentlemen. Zine America, baby.
Live and local. This is 560.
The radio is all yours now.
QAM.
By Sandis Orsland scored a winning goal for Anaheim last night.
Packwood can't keep his pecker in his pants.
Queen awake on face she plays.
Coltrane was a hit parade.
Crows like us we had it made. Those were the days.
And you knew who you were then.
There were no black Republicans.
And we could use a man like Walter.
All the guys I knew were straight.
Whitey was the teacher, hey.
King Eldorado ran gray. Those were the days.
945, 560, WQM. 132 votes on air, and isn't that interesting? What's your take on the war with Iraq? I'm strongly against it, 43. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 26. All for it, let's rule, 24, that's 18.1%. Aren't you surprised that those people are all for it, like,
shocked.
18%. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 20. Let's take care of North Korea first, 13, and don't know, 6.
Don't know.
5670560, pound 560, Don.
No.
On the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line, screenless 9 to 10 hour. We'll still do that. Because we don't want to have you guys having it, you know.
Work.
Work too hard in there during the 9 to 10 hour. Especially while our blood sugar is like swirling all around and trying to adjust and find a happy medium. After all those potato pancakes and chunks of French toast.
Is that John Edward or the other gay guy?
Thanks a lot to our friends at Corky's, even though they sent it to the wrong show. Do not be sending Mono food no more, please. Unless we get it. WQAM, hello. Yes, sir.
Jeffrey from West Palm Beach on the mobile would like to make a comment about Challenger.
Go right ahead.
Oh, thank you. How are you doing, Neil?
Okay.
First of all, the Palm Beach Post, in the main section, I don't know if in the accent section, has a big story on a guy who wrote a long story. You mentioned that they wanted to send this shuttle up to coincide with Reagan's State of the Union address.
Yes.
You're also forgetting the PR effort to put the teacher into space.
Right. I'm not forgetting that.
Okay,
because,
good.
Because when they gave the president the word that it had exploded, he said, oh, is that the one with the school teacher on it?
Yeah, very. Of course, we were in the Cold War then, so it was real important to send them up at all
right.
costs.
Send them a message.
Yep. Thank you, guy.
Thank you. Of course, Ronnie forgot all about that by now, I'm sure. Fives, isn't it amazing how he just keeps, I don't know.
What? Living?
Whatever it is. Whatever you'd want to call it.
Pretty amazing.
5, 6, 7, because there are a lot of people who thought that he was like, kind of like back then, too, that he wasn't quite
right.
All
right. Well.
But he did remember his lines.
Yeah, but
least.
He looked good up there with the hair.
He did?
Dippity doing his hair.
With all that shoe polish, that
right?
Black Kiwi shoe polish in his hair?
That's it.
Not my type. WQAM.
How you doing, Leo?
Okay, sir.
Listen, I set my resume down to screw in. I thought I would call you to get
the
inside
sports?
Poop.
But you got to love sports, first of all. You got to be a sports nerd. You have to have a blow-up OJ doll at home or else you don't qualify.
Well, can I sell your show?
No. No, that's not the salespeople that are involved with these shows. It's they're involved with the ball games. Like the Marlins and stuff like that.
Oh, Christ.
Yeah. That's why everybody left here. That's what they said.
I'd rather stick what I'm doing, cleaning out toilets.
Good thinking. Have a great day, sir.
Okay.
Good choice. Yeah, call up Screw Ann. You'll notice even George pointed that out during the last time we played that silly-ass thing. If you love sports, if you're obsessed with sports,
it's
if you're a sports nerd, right.
Spot.
That's how it starts out. Because aside from that, nothing else really counts. And you're willing to work for a real nasty, hateful bitch. I don't want to hear it again. Even Mo was saying that Screw Ann was a nasty bitch and throws food at people. See, he's starting to butch up a little bit. Well, I guess when he realized I saw him out there in the hall with that thing crawling around on his head, I guess he figured he got to, like, cover up for it. I saw it, Mo. It was moving. It was alive. At least part of him is anyway. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T. The one thing you put in here that I love the best is...
Take off those checkered pants.
I love that.
Thank you, Carlos.
WQAM.
Hey, please forgive me. If you've already talked about this morning, but I just turned on your show.
We forgive you.
What happened at WRMF yesterday morning?
I don't know. What did happen to him?
Well, I was surfing around, and I came in there, and there was a message saying, this is the general manager of WRMF, and if you heard our morning show this morning, We apologize if you were offended. We don't know if you're going to hear the same DJs tomorrow.
Really?
And, yeah.
Must be the word police are out after them now. I mean, they're making the rounds after everybody.
I'm sure Rick and Suds are poised to attack.
Okay, we'll pass it along.
Thanks.
Thanks. We'll find out for you. How do you like that, WRMF? Maybe they mentioned what the MF stood for in WRMF. You think so?
Maybe. Or they made an insensitive
joke. As in Mighty
joke.
Fine? Made an insensitive joke? Or maybe they made a politically incorrect joke. Something like that. Ooh. Oh, guess who's going to be on Larry King tonight at 9 o'clock?
Yo, you already told me.
Condoleezza is going to be on 9 o'clock tonight. And you do respect her a lot, don't you?
No.
Oh, neither do I. And I won't be watching. I'll be at the hockey game. WQAM.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good, sir.
All right. I'm calling from Fort Lauderdale.
Well, nobody's perfect.
Am I? Oh, I'm on the air?
It sounds just like you.
Oh, get out. Oh, listen.
Okay, I would like to get out right now. Can you go take a nap after all this blood sugar problem I got? Go ahead.
Okay.
Eat all those potato pancakes, man. Your head starts spinning like Linda Blair, like a dreidel in heat.
I became a dedicated listener to you guys. You guys are outstanding.
Yes, we are.
Oh, yes.
Although we don't love sports. I like sports a little bit. George hates it, and Carlos don't understand it. But we're not sports lovers, which is why we stand out above the rest of these sports, the jock-sniffing crowd. But go ahead. You were saying,
okay.
As Donnie likes to say, you wanted to say.
My opinion on this going into Iraq, I think it's a fatal mistake.
Yeah.
And
it's going to be fatal for a lot of people, I'll tell you that.
No, and for him to tell him to throw down his arms, you know, it's like during the American Revolution, it's like the British coming over here to tell us to throw down our arms.
Lay down your arms. By the Cordettes, I remember that. Lay down your arms. Remember that song, George?
Yeah, I do.
But I don't think those people should become defenseless, you know, when somebody's coming to attack them.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're scared crapless, and like that Time magazine thing, 84% of the Europeans think the U.S. is the most dangerous country in the world right now. We got them scared. If that was our goal in all of this, to scare the crap out of the world, we're doing a good job of it.
Oh, yes, we are. And it's not, there's no smoking guns. Every time they come up with something, and I've been waiting for it, and there's nothing.
Well, let me ask you this. Where are you right now? Where are you calling from? From a house, from a building, from a car?
Oh, no, I'm on the cell.
You're what?
I'm on the cell phone.
Welcome to my world.
Where are you?
In Fort Lauderdale.
No, I don't mean that, but like in a place, a building?
Oh, no, I'm in a vehicle.
In a vehicle. Okay, well, let me ask you. Do you have drugs in your vehicle?
No.
Prove it.
There you go.
See? There you go.
All right. This one point.
I think you got him. I think you got him, and what we're going to do is we'll trace the call, we'll have them pull you over, the authority, the pot police, and they'll search your car, they'll tear it all apart, and if we don't find anything, you know what that'll show us? That you're doing a real good job of hiding it.
Right, somewhere. And then I might be convicted for hiding that.
Right, that's right, exactly. Now you're catching on.
Right, and so I think that's a whole bunch of crap. I can't wait till this administration get the hell up out of the office.
Amen.
And have some kind of decent administration come in there.
Almost anybody at this point. Maybe even the real Alfred E. Newman. Okay, have a great day, pal.
All right,
and drive like a bat out of hell when you hear those sirens.
All right.
Okay, they're after you. Well, prove that you don't have drugs in there right now. Do you? Don't believe it. Don't believe it. See, they're lying about it.
I'm hiding them.
See, it reminds me of that scene from Monty Python, The Life of Brian. Wasn't that the one where they said, he who is the savior will deny it?
Right.
Right? I'm not the savior. And then he said, he denies it. Okay, I am the savior. It's kind of a lose-lose situation is what it is. Lose-lose. Well, we don't have a smoking gun. And of course, they got those big missiles. Of course, there wasn't anything in them. There was nothing in them.
See, they're hiding the content.
Oh, boy. WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
San Antonio's trade.
Yes.
Already paying dividends.
Yeah, he got the winning goal line. Don't play that thing. I changed my mind. I'll talk about whatever I want, George. Don't play Rimmer. Oh, and thank you, but it reminds me of the Rimmer story. So anyway, Rimmer, oh, my God, he calls me yesterday to announce to me.
If it's free, it's me.
Yeah, well, we know that. Wants brownie points for the fact that he went into Pizza Loft with his whole family over this last weekend. Family's down here visiting, the son and daughter, because it's All-Star weekend. Going to the Pizza Loft, and Davey Jeff Cohen wasn't there, and he paid for the entire meal. No discount, paid for the whole thing. So on the one hand, it sounded like he wanted brownie points for it, but on the other hand, he made it very clear he wasn't too happy about it, Jeff, because his name isn't in the computer. I guess Jeff's got a computer there with names of people who get freebies like me and Scott Cowan.
Right.
Anybody else? Al Goldstein. I don't know who else. bunch of lowlifes like us. But at any rate, and Jeff's name isn't in there. I mean, Jeff Rimmer. So he had to pay the entire thing. So I had to promise him that I'd come out of here today. Didn't have to, but I did because I'm a very good guy. And bitch and bellyache that Jeff Cohen didn't have his name in there, so we had to pay the whole thing. Full price. This is after they drove across the street from his $2 million house, his brand new house that he had built to his specs. Yeah, the tears are rolling down George's eye. Who still wants to know where the free lunch is, Rimmer, okay? He still wants to know where the free meal is.
Just have a
cheap bastard.
If it's free, it's me.
Yeah, and where's my $14, too, as a matter of fact? So the best thing is, yesterday, I'm looking, I have a box in a drawer in my room, my bedroom, that's got like all business cards and all that kind of stuff that I've accumulated over the last few years that people give me. And I, rather than have it in my wallet, which would weigh 600 pounds, and I got a fat enough ass already, I stick it in this box. So I'm looking for something specific in there, and I find a card somebody gave me, and it says, free meal for Rimmer on the card. So I look at the card, and it's one of my listeners, somebody who also is obviously a Panther fan or knows who Rimmer is, who's got a restaurant, an Italian restaurant in New York. So when the Panthers play, the Rangers or the Islanders went in the city, he invites Rimmer to come in there and eat for free. So I tell him that I had found this card. I went and I got it out of the box. And he says, oh, save that. I can use it when we go to New York. Like the famous time we ate at Ruth's Chris, and they picked up the tab, and they put that nice card. Instead of putting a check on the table at the end of the meal, they put a very lovely card down there. Thank you so much. We always enjoy having you. Please accept this meal as on a house. And I'm about to take the card and put it like whatever. Save the card for next time, he says. Save that card for
like
next time.
Like it's a coupon?
Yeah. Like they won't remember that it was the last time with the free meal. So if there's anybody who ever told you an honest thing,
if it's free, it's me.
We're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Hey, Whitney has a pair.
The temperature is zero. It is cold. It is so freaking cold. And I cringe every time the wind blows. In my pants, something is shrinking. I'm so cold, I can't lip sync.
He is one good-looking guy.
That's because it's zero, baby. And I cannot feel my toes. There's a tingling in my fingers. And my private parts are froze. Oh, my nose is about to fall off. There's a cloud every time that I cough. And my hands are blue. They are turning numb. They might amputate my thumbs. That's because it's zero, baby. I can barely move my mouth. Oh, no. I'm a red-hot Latin lover. But first I need to be thawed out. Yes, I need to be thawed out. That's because it's zero. I say frio.
10:02 at 560 WQAM. It's cold, all right. Let me heat it up for you. Anyway, it's our big 10 to 11 hour, and then we got the 11 to noon hour, and then noon to 1 we got the Comedy Bits hour. Why is he like all bundled up in there? You know something? And now I know who did it in here last night. Turned the thermostat up. He did. He must be another one of these frigid people like you that's always frozen.
The rooms are in balance.
It was 76 degrees in here. I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, is it the potato pancakes? Was it the French toast
having
chunks?
A sugar reaction.
And I'm looking on there at 75.7. It was shut on 75. And now it's shut on 71 because I turned it down and now it's starting to get a little cool. And he's like all hunched up with a jacket on there like he's in the Arctic Circle or something, jerk. Man, what is wrong with you? So anyway, we'll be playing Comedy Bits noon to one. We're going back, whatever prompted me to do that. Was it Eric's idea or Carlos?
No, it was a dead ass morning. It was your idea.
It was a bad idea. Of doing 9 to 10, that was a bad idea.
Let's do it again.
No, I'm not going to do it again. Well, 10 to 11 might be good. No, seriously, that was a terrible idea. It's just so damn frustrating that these people over here, they move so slowly, you know. Well, they understand that this show really ought to be on from 10 to 2 or else it's something. And they're thinking about it. They're examining it. They're putting a stethoscope up their each other's ass. They're considering. They're holding hands. They're calling signals in the huddle, you know, whatever they're doing. And in the meantime, we're like, well, so we'll do the best we can. That's all we can do, you know. You can't be better than number one. We'd like to have a bigger number than that. And, of course, if George wouldn't chase him away in the summertime and I'd stop reading bedtime stories, then maybe we might have the younger audience back. But
I'm
don't.
Sorry.
Huh? No, we don't care if they're 100. We don't give a crap as long as they listen. Well, even if they hate us like poison. Now, I do want to say this. The poll that we're taking right now, it goes to show you. I've always told you that the people who tend to be politically a little on the right, if you catch my drift, that they're a little more dedicated than the rest of us. And so, as a result, now it's up to 23%. It was right there at 18%, which it always seems to be the Bush people, you know, the ones who would follow him over the edge of a cliff, kind of like you saw in Smallville last night, but Clark won't be there to catch us. Damn it. So I would just suggest that those people who are like war protesters and have other ideas might want to like get heavy duty on the poll also, since they're loading it up. I checked to make sure we weren't being freeped by those freep assholes, you know, the ones who like to love. I mean, it's like a bunch of little children. We're going to get in there. We're going to show them. We're going to, like, twist the results of the poll as if that changes anybody's opinion, which it does not. Just stupid. People with too much time on their hands. Why don't they go out and do something constructive, like playing golf? Speaking of people with too much time on their hands, Rimmer. What's your take on the war with Iraq? I'm strongly against it, 54. Haven't been convinced it's justified yet, 54. That's 49.6% right there. All for it. Let's roll, 50, 23% out of 218 votes. I support it, but I'm nervous about 29. Let's take care of North Korea first, 22, and don't know, as in nine votes. They don't know. They're busy watching other people play golf. 5670560. We're doing screenless today, by the way, George.
Oh, excellent.
We want to put a lot of pressure on you because you've exerted so much energy gesticulating and Rumpelstiltskin in there for Carlos. What is he screaming about anyway? What's he getting all like motivated? I know it's nothing. Probably about something that stupid blind date thing you're watching in the morning. And he's bouncing up. And even Muff came in here and said, gee, the walls are shaking. If you were that animated when you were on the air, we'd have at least a 5 share anyway. You might have a number instead of all these people saying that you're a mumbler and terminally boring. If you got that animated on the air like I do.
All these people?
Yeah, both of your listeners. No, seriously, get a little more animated on the air. Save it the energy for when you're on the air, not like off the air when nobody's paying any attention. You think he gives a crap? He couldn't care less what you're talking
about. Anything.
He couldn't care. Just give him the $1.75 an hour, let him take a few fag breaks out there, go outside in front, and that's all he cares about. Come in here at night and diddle with my computer.
Did he get a raise he doesn't know about, $1.75?
50 cents an hour, net. 5670560, #560. On the AT&T and Verizon line. Now, we could put on Colin Powell at 10:30 when he's going to start speaking at the UN, but we won't. Not that we don't want to put some of it on, but he's going to be talking for an hour and a half, and we can't afford the luxury. People that want to see it, it's on all the networks, okay? Exactly. Plus, there's no smoking gun. You got it? We know you're hiding it from us. We know you're really no threat to us, but we don't really care about that since this deal was decided over a year ago, last January, when Karl Rove said, we're playing the war card. Ha, ha, ha. We're playing the war card. I mean, it's just hopeless. There's just that element, and it's on all sides politically. That's why politics sucks so bad all over the world, especially here, because we live here. At least I do part of the time. Is because you got people who are just blinded to the blinded by the right, like that bit says, or by the left, or whoever they get sucked in by. They're all a bunch of crooks, let's face it. It's just a question of which ones are most dangerous. And right now, we know exactly who's the most dangerous.
Yeah.
WQAM.
George?
Yes.
Hey, how are you?
Pretty good.
Good morning.
Would you like to hear me mumble?
I got some good news for you.
Okay.
Oh, I'm on, I thought it was George. Hey,
you
Neil, how are you?
You want to speak to George? You sound a little bit disappointed now.
No, not at all. How are you?
I'm doing good.
I gleaned some good news. This was actually for George, but you might be interested.
Yeah.
And from the New York Times this morning, that the DEA is not doing a good job.
What
no,
that,
really, huh?
What does that mean?
The Drug Enforcement Agency.
Yeah.
Has not stemmed any kind of.
Well, is that a bulletin?
No, it's well, it's a bulletin that they're actually realizing it, you know.
Yeah.
They're doing a good job in California, busting the medicinal
right.
people.
Yeah, Ed, actually, well, Ed Rosenthal...
Just like that article that I read before, the fact that the United States attorney made a desperate attempt to get Mr. Rosenthal's bail revoked, this guy that they're hanging out to dry, that goes to show you that whether they're doing a good job or not, they are compelled to continue doing this crap because they have to protect their bureaucracy. Otherwise, if there's no DEA, they're all out on the street.
Just like any other government bureaucracy.
Right, that's right.
Itself.
Exactly.
All right. Thank you.
Good luck to you, sir, and don't try it, okay? I guess this guy thinks he was going to tell you about it. I guess he thinks you're a druggie or something, okay? What's that, one of your customers?
Where would he get that impression?
5670560. Well, every time I say that, you get so defensive. You sell drugs, okay?
No.
Prove it.
9 minutes
after 10, and Carlos buys them, don't you? Prove
not
it. Oh,
me.
He says yes.
I want to know where he's buying them.
He is just a little prick. You know, there's just nothing like it. No wonder he can bathe in the sink. And by the way, I saw Mo was on her way to the... as soon as Carlos made a beeline in there, Mo was on her way in there to help him adjust his toothbrush. He wanted to help him scrub it. 9 minutes after 10 at 560 WQM, you ever presented with an opportunity when you should have, could have, would have, or did something, but you didn't when you passed? Oh, boy. But there's an incredible Fannie Mae mortgage rate out there at 3.45%, and this rate's available by calling Financial Group toll-free, 1-800-940-5363. What is that? 1-800-940-5363. If you were to compare a 7% rate with 3.45%, you'd save $3,500 in the first year loan for each $100,000 that you owe. $100,000 cost you only $447 a month. Here's an opportunity that won't last because it's a 40-year low. So if you've been thinking about refinancing or buying a home, call Financial Group toll-free, 1-800-940-5363. The process is simple, and the call is absolutely, positively free. You got nothing to lose but a big chunk off what you're paying every month. 1-800-940-LEND. Financial Group has been an equal housing lender to thousands of borrowers with the Fannie Mae program. Credit restrictions do apply. Rates are subject to change if you wait too long, so don't diddle around. 5.34 APR, by the way. Call Financial Group today. Get all the details. There is no obligation. Call toll-free, 1-800-940-LEND.
This is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
O-R-O-N. Welcome back to the superfluous cunnilinguists of the Mohammed and David Show, where we got the three callers on power rotation for your perusal.
Hey, Mo!
What? This better not be about hokey.
We got special guests today.
No one's allowed in here unless they bring food for their king.
It's too late. Sack already booked them.
How are you?
Who the hell are these muzzlemoots?
That's the Rican sons. You know, drive home with us today.
Go to hell.
Sorry.
I never heard of you, bum.
Well, I wonder why.
Well, what do you do? You got an act?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
Like what?
We spin the wheel. Wherever the wheel stops, we grab meat off of it. We slam it. You name it.
What's funny about that?
Well, you got a point there.
Why can't you just ask me a question?
You ready to put your head in the toilet bowl?
You think that's funny, huh? Well, I got news for you, pal. You both stink. Jackals on the precipice of getting fired at them right now.
What a bummer.
Get out of my place of business.
No.
All right, something. I'll give you one more chance to show me what you got.
I hope this isn't really funny because I got a really full bladder.
All right, these are things that probably adults would know.
Yeah.
They're like old sayings, and I want you to fill in the blank. You know how to do that?
Yeah.
Here we go. The bigger they are, the harder they...
get to do.
Yeah!
What do you think, that's funny? Did I give Clarence clearance to give you clearance to laugh? How dare you laugh at me? I suppose you want to rape me now, huh?
Yeah,
start licking.
That would be wild, yeah.
All right. I don't even care anymore. Hey, Gildy, hold my green pants.
Okay.
What are you looking at?
Freckle face Fanny.
And you guys got a condo?
That's condo, Mo.
What of it?
Yeah.
I do. I mean, I don't. Suds does.
Mine. And I might as well warn you, I didn't douche today.
Okay. Now you have to say, spin your meat, Rick and Suds.
Spin your meat, Rick and...
Let's do it.
Oh, Gunner.
Well, what's the matter?
I was shooting fudge.
Well, see, I told you it's not my day. I'm so embarrassed. Shooting fudge ain't funny, okay? It's downright embarrassing. Personal.
God.
Uh-oh. Kleenex.
Maybe that's what Mo was talking about Scranton candy. And I haven't had fudge in years, you know what? Have you?
Now that you mention it, no.
I love fudge.
It's great.
You don't like fudge? Well, that's right. It's
like
chocolate. You're
yeah.
such an asshole, man. You don't like anything good. And don't be turning the heat up here to 80 degrees anymore, please. Not while I'm here. Anyway, American Airlines urges $1.8 billion in cuts to save the airline. American's about on a verge, too. How do you like that? And United? What have we got left when you come right down to it? You got KLM Northwest, right? That's like
right.
They're together, and they're not in good shape either. You got Air Canada. Thank God, Helen. Thank God for you guys. Who else we got?
Delta.
Delta is ready when you are sometime, and if not, you're out of luck anyway.
Right.
TWA? Not. Pan Am? Not.
Nope. Eastern.
Not.
Crazy Clown.
What's
I mean, Value Jet.
Value Jet, not. With a little clown on there, clowning around. Virgin Air is still around if you want to go on there with that goofball.
Yeah. Courtney.
Yeah, Courtney's love, Cox. So that's it. 5670560. That's really sad. And America's sitting back going, oh, what are we going to do about that space shuttle? I mean, it was sad, like I said. How many hours and days we got? Oh, the delegates are arriving at the UN.
Ahoy!
How do you like that? And they're getting ready for Colin Powell to open up his mouth and say there's no smoking gun button, and he's going to go on for an hour and a half of speculate. Well, we got to do this now because Sodom's a bad guy, and he stole a freight train or two. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. Here's our only call on screenless. That's pretty scary. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yes, good morning. I would like to give my perspective on Iraq before our Secretary of State begins.
Yes.
Okay, the way I see it is, even if we do bring about a democracy to Iraq and rid of that tyranny, we're going to have a problem because if you think about it, Saudi Arabia, that's borders Iraq to the south, right? They're our biggest ally in that region. So it would be kind of awkward if you think about it that on the one hand we will be bringing about a democracy to one country and on the other hand we will be supporting a monarchy that suppresses its people.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean...
And what about Iran?
Oh, that's another thing. Let me tell you something that most Americans don't realize, unfortunately, geographically we're a little...
And what about Pakistan?
Exactly. But see, with Iraq the problem is Syria, that's located to its west, and Iran, that's located to its east, Turkey to the north.
Yeah, I know the map, yeah.
You know, exactly. See, if we destabilize Iraq, because think about it, going into a country is not exactly going to be an easy task. I don't care how these people want to portray it. You know, so, and even if we are successful, what I'm worried about is the aftermath of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because if we go in there and we bring about democracy, a lot of people in the Middle East are saying, hey, what are the Americans doing? They're bringing about democracy and they're supporting, the monarchy. Hey, that's why Osama bin Laden justified the attacks. Because he kept saying, hey, the Americans are being hypocrites because they're a democracy, yet they're advocating a monarchy that suppresses its people. And it's true. There is no liberty in Saudi Arabia.
Or in Jordan.
Or
in Syria.
Or in
Lebanon.
Exactly.
Kuwait.
Or in Egypt.
Did I say Libya?
Or in Kuwait. We went in there and risked American lives to bail out Kuwait after Saddam invaded and took over a sovereign country, and the Kuwaiti princes were busy in
London.
In London and elsewhere in the discos, partying and getting drunk and having a great time with all of our oil money.
Or Pakistan, for that matter, our buddies.
Oh yeah, our good buddies, Pakistan, that liberal of that bastion of liberal democracy,
where we support a obnoxious dictator.
Right. Who also has nukes, by the way.
Who deposed the elected leader, by the way.
Who put the Taliban into power in Afghanistan, by the way. We just mentioned that in passing. Who selected them practically hand-picked. Who also opened up all those madrasas, which the Saudis taught them how to do, but nevertheless they were willing co-conspirators.
And who they fought.
Open up all those madrasas that they funded so that they could brainwash all the young men to hate the West and kill us. Our good friends, the Pakistanis, other than that, they're wonderful folks. Never stole a freight train. So this business of picking and choosing, and also the thing, anybody saw 60 Minutes about North Korea Sunday night, if that didn't just scare the living daylights out of you. I mean, there is virtually nobody there other than the very, very, the wealthiest of the wealthy, and even they have no running water. They don't.
Except for the rain.
Then
it
runs
down
the
road.
They have no running water, so I guess they didn't bring in a lot of bottled water. I'm not going to speculate on
the
brand.
It runs down the gutter.
Yeah. Gutter is a good word for it, North Korea, the way those people are living. And, of course, he's got all the military. They're all goose-stepping along. He's got a million military. He's a crazy person. But we're not, we'll deal with him diplomatically. Even though, of course, as we spoke the other day, and as we speak right now, they're moving things around. They're getting ready now to start, mobilizing the moving the plutonium. They're getting ready to start pumping up the nuclear weapons, everything they got. But we're a little bit concerned because if we did anything with them, you know, how many people in Seoul and Tokyo could be dead within a matter of hours? Oh. See, well, I guess we're not really concerned about is the aftermath of what's going to happen. For example, we had it on the website, but I don't like to read these because they're too depressing. We're supposed to be entertaining. On yesterday's bedtime stories, arrest of al-Qaeda terrorists disrupt plans for attack. This is one from the ultra-right-wing Washington Times, not some liberal pinko magazine or newspaper. Al-Qaeda is planning a mass casualty attack to rival 9/11, but preparations have been disrupted by arrest of terrorists during the past several months, according to U.S. intelligence officials. Recent intelligence reports indicate that communications among clandestine cells of al-Qaeda members are being restored gradually, they said. The attack will be on a large scale, one official said. Additionally, the intelligence report stated that any major attack is likely to be preceded by smaller-scale strikes, including assassinations of prominent people in the U.S. Officials didn't provide details on the latest threat, which was contained in intelligence reports sent to senior Bush administration officials last week. The warning didn't say whether the attacks would be in the U.S. or abroad. We continue to be in a heightened threat environment, said U.S. officials, with access to intelligence reports who declined to comment further. So what's going to happen if we start dropping the first bombs on Baghdad? We don't know, but we can assume it probably isn't going to be very good.
No.
And we're not talking about just one big mass attack like he's talking about here. There's nothing to say that we're at that point not going to start seeing isolated attacks, car bombings like they're used to in the Middle East every single day.
Right. Snipings.
Shopping plazas being blown up. Little things like that. Suicide bombers right here on our soil. Because that'll be the excuse that they've been waiting for. These are the seeds that Osama Yamama was planting. That's what he wanted. This is exactly what he wanted. And we're goose-stepping along. Of course, the oil has nothing to do with it. We do want you to understand. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. WQAM. WQAM.
Hey, Neil, how are you?
Okay, sir.
The real enemy, though, is the French. I mean, if you really want to get somebody involved.
The real enemy is the French?
The French.
Why
absolutely.
Is that?
Well, they're attacking us right now.
Yeah.
The French is the hub of the terrorists. I mean, this is really the main supporters of what is wrong with everything in our global nation.
They represent everything that's wrong. Well, I mean, I have no love for the
French. They're our allies, allegedly.
No, they're not our allies.
You're right.
We finally said that the other day, and that's one of the few honest things that's come out of the Pentagon recently. They're not our allies. What would you like us to do? Would you like us to bomb Paris? Would that make you feel good?
I think that's what we should do. Absolutely. And then hit the Germans next.
Yeah, okay, great. And then we'll be over to your house. 5670. So in other words, anybody who doesn't agree with us.
Well,
but that's exactly what's going on in this country right now. Don't remember what the president said? There's no in between. You either are with us or you're against us. No sitting on the fence. No Switzerland. No neutrality. No like we're thinking about it. None of that. Either you're with us or against us. It's the black and white world. The good guys over here and the bad guys over there. And that's it. And this jackass that we just spoke to, that's his mentality. That's what he believes. Nobody here is defending the French. They're scum. I've always said that long before any of this stuff going on. But we're not at war with the French. And if anybody wants to talk about who's responsible, the Saudis would be a real good place to start. Saudi Arabia, North Korea 1, Saudi Arabia 2, Pakistan 3, and then if we got some time left over, Sodom number 4. Because he ain't going anywhere anyway. He's got no military left to begin with.
Right.
See, that's the question you have to ask yourself. Does he really represent a threat to us? Well, and by the way, these missiles that contained nothing, that were empty,
right,
they had
blanks.
A range of 20 miles, I'm sorry, not 200, 20 miles.
Yeah.
Basically useless.
That can't clear the border.
Right. That's right. But don't confuse, there's Colin Powell standing by with Jack Straw. You know Jack Straw?
Yes.
I think he's the last straw.
That's probably the more likely problem out there is we're not going to get that again.
Oh, well, good. Thank God for that. We're not going to get that again. Thank the Lord for that. How's the poll coming, Neil? What's your take on war with Iraq? And let me just say this right now. I mean, this is one of the reasons that it's such a waste of time. I guess it helps us all get it out of our system. But what you discuss on here now and all these peace protests, they're not having any impact because this has already been decided upon. That's why Colin Powell, who was the one dove that they had in there, who was trying to hold all of this off for months and months, he finally sold out.
They got to him.
He sold out. He's there to make the case today. Not a question of if. It's a question of when. Make no mistake about it. Your take on the war with Iraq. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 89. All for it, let's roll, 81. All of a sudden, just now, that came up there, 24.9%. See what I'm saying about those people? I'm strongly against it, 70, 21.5%. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 46. Let's take care of North Korea first, 30, and don't know, 9. 9. Don't know. Oh, there it is, Powell. There'll be no smoking gun. In other words, they don't really have any evidence. It's just they can't prove that they don't have this. They don't can't prove they don't have that.
They don't like his mustache.
Right. And they're not really sure it's him anyway. 26 after 10 at 560 WQM. Tom Lehman and Joe Prieto are buried up to their armpits in vehicles because Hallett has been sent so many cars by the factory they have no place to stick them. Even Tom Lehman is parking cars and trucks and all kinds of stuff in his driveway, so they need to place one in yours. That's what they're looking for. And that's why Hallett right now is blowing out all the new vehicles regardless of profit, including the Pontiac Vibe starting only $13,998, and you get up to $5,000 off on every GMC Envoy in stock, plus get 0% financing or up to a $3,000 rebate. Of course, Hallett also has a great selection of pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs, like always. And if credit's a problem for you, if that's one of the reasons you're terrified even to step on the lot at a car dealership, if everybody else in town turns up their nose when even see you coming, have no fear because Hallett is here. Credit's not a problem for you there. It's the Winter Blizzard Emergency Clearance Sale. It's going on right this moment at Hallett Pontiac GMC, and you'll find them in the same stupendous location. They've been treating people great and making unbeatable deals. 13401 South Dixie Highway, that's the always one across from the falls. For over 35 years, they've been doing it there. They're open every day, 7 days a week. And you'll save even more if you mention my name. Call right now. Call the Neil Rogers Neil Deal Hotline. Toll free, 1-888-534-4211. That's 1-888-534-4211 for Hallett Pontiac GMC, who be professional grade.
Live and local, we're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Right over here.
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
Iraq's a crappy little country. Smells like the mustache on his face. Just get rid of that. You're in drinking chubby and blow up the whole goddamn place. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
One time.
Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker. Saddam Hussein's a motherfucker.
1032 at 560 WQM, 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. Hotel Queen Leona howls, "I've been robbed," as jury wallops her for 11 million big ones.
Oh!
A Manhattan grand jury got downright nasty. A Manhattan jury with Leona Helmsley yesterday slapping her with an $11.175 million verdict for discriminating against a gay employee. Oh, well, the billionaire quipped after the four-woman, two-man jury soaked her for the spectacular sum, finding she'd subjected Charles Bell to a hostile work environment when he was general manager of her Park Lane Hotel. What am I going to lose now, my virginity, she said. But she quickly made it clear she was not amused. I feel I've been robbed, she said. The jury took just 4 hours to find that Bell's sexuality was a motivating factor in Helmsley's decision to fire him after he'd spent just 4 months on the job, causing him severe emotional distress. This shows Mrs. Hemsley is not above the law, Bell said. She can't act this way toward her employees. The so-called queen of mean didn't act as if she'd been chastised, however, and while she showed no reaction while the verdict was read, she vented her royal wrath on the jury, Bell, and the judge after the proceeding was over. They're crazy. They don't like me, I guess, she said of the jurors, referring to their verdict as shameful. It's encouraging more people to use dope, to cheat, to steal, she said. Bell broke every rule, etc. and so on. Well, too bad. Cough it up, bitch. And don't be picking on Tom Cruise, who is going to be holding a press conference right after Colin Powell finishes, by the way, to announce that he's not gay. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. Any second now, they're going to be doing it.
Any objection?
No, I object right now. We're in the middle of an important show. WQAM.
Any second now, they're going to be...
Hello.
Hello,
Neil. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Neil, you were talking about North Korea.
Yeah.
But you leave out the fact that in 94, Clinton signed that agreement with them, gave them $500 million, the blackmail,
yeah,
and two reactors. And then they cheated on that, and they built the nukes anyways, but now it's too late. Now,
and you notice that they only ratcheted up after this whole evil empire thing started, this evildoers thing? after we alienated them?
Well, building a nuclear bomb is not done over a six-month or a year period.
Yeah.
They have been building
it. Well, what does that have to do with what's going on now? See, what you want to do is play politics. Bill Clinton did this, and yeah, Bill Clinton sat by also, and they could have had a chance to get Osama, and they sent one cruise missile after him, and oops, it was a little bit too late. Or two, whatever the hell it was.
No, well, Clinton threatened Clinton isn't the president right now, okay, sir?
Clinton's not in office right now. George W. Bush is in office. Quit playing Clinton bashing, all right? He's not there anymore. Which I'm sure depresses you greatly because he got nothing to talk about. He's been gone for 2 years plus. And Clinton did this and Papa Bush did that. Well, that's unfortunate, but in the meantime, that's what we're faced with in the world today, okay? Where's that article about North Korea, by the way? Do I have it? Do I got it? Oh, yeah, here it is. Nick Kristof. We had it on the website yesterday. Our bedtime story. He says the North Korean nuclear crisis is far more perilous than many people realize. The White House, wanting to keep the focus on Iraq, did not even bother to tell us that satellite images show North Korea apparently taking steps toward reprocessing plutonium. It was left to my New York Times colleague, David Sanger, to alert the public just a few days ago. Can you imagine if it were Iraq that had been spotted moving nuclear fuel around? The news that the Pentagon is reinforcing its preparedness on the Korean Peninsula suggests that it doesn't believe the White House lullabies either. When North Korea has reprocessed its plutonium and built five more nuclear weapons probably by summer, it'll try to pressure us into a new package deal. To understand how dangerous the Korean Peninsula could become, consider one worst-case scenario. February 14, the CIA confirms that North Korea is reprocessing plutonium, making a preemptive U.S. military strike more difficult because of the risk of radiation leakage. September 15, this is not a crisis, the White House declares. March 17, North Korea announces it will resume missile tests, stocks plunge in Tokyo and Seoul. March 26, North Korea test fires a two-stage Tapadong 2 missile. It soars over Japan, knocking 9% off the Tokyo stock market. CIA analysts warn that a three-stage version of the Tapadong 2 could reach U.S. mainland. March 27, this is not a major crisis, the White House declares. April 7th, on the birthday of the late great leader, Kim Il-sung, North Korea resumes construction of a nuclear reactor in Taichung that will be capable of producing plutonium for 44 warheads annually. May 1st, the UN Security Council approves sanctions. Without Chinese enforcement, they mean little. June 29th, North Korea completes reprocessing, and the plutonium is dispersed to be made into warheads. July 10th, North Korea tests a nuclear device. Stocks tumble worldwide, leading a big Japanese bank to the edge of bankruptcy. July 12th. North Korea formally declares itself a nuclear state, proudly asserting that the Korean bomb will be used on behalf of all Koreans to combat Japanese and American aggressors. Stocks plunge worldwide, triggering a Japanese banking crisis and a global recession. July 13th, this is not a monumental crisis, the White House says. July 15, Tokyo's mayor, Ishihara, launches a campaign for prime minister on a platform of building nuclear weapons. July 20th, with its plutonium safely hidden, North Korea begins to pressure the U.S. to negotiate a package solution to the crisis. Its troops spray machine gun fire across the DMZ. South Korean and Japanese stock markets fall 7%. August 1st, a sealed vial of anthrax is found in an Osaka subway car. No one is hurt, but some commentators suggest it's a message from North Korea to U.S. You better talk to us. August 5th, Iranian and Libyan nuclear buyers are spotted shipping in Pyongyang. August 6th, we shouldn't exaggerate the crisis, the White House says. As we've said from the beginning, we're always ready to sit down with North Korea and talk. August 13th, Don Rumsfeld offers three military options to President Bush. The minimal one calls for a cruise missile strike on North Korea's no-nuclear facilities, but because the plutonium has been reprocessed and the warheads are hidden, we can't take out its nuclear arsenal. The maximal one also destroys North's air defense system and much of its artillery. August 16th, intelligence intercepts suggest that North Korea respond to even a minimal U.S. military strike by launching conventional missiles at Japan and to a broader strike by turning Seoul into a sea of fire. The CIA warns that if North finds itself losing conventional war, it'll use chemical, biological, and possibly nuclear weapons against Japan and U.S. forces in South Korea. All sides brace for a new Korean War, which the CIA estimates could kill a million people. August 17, Colin Powell is told by President Bush, if only we'd listened to you 2 years ago about the need to engage North Korea, even this February if we'd only started negotiations. I'm sorry, Colin, we blew it. Then Mr. Powell wakes up and realizes he was dreaming. Wrote Nick Kristof in yesterday's New York Times.
Oh, that's just
that has been outstanding since 1998.
Well, thanks very much, Colin. We're delighted to hear that. He's been outstanding since 1998, and he is mild. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. How's that poll coming? What's your take on war with Iraq? As the Secretary of State is making the case right now as we speak.
I might add at this point that we are providing all relevant information we can.
Good. What's your take? Haven't been convinced that it's justified, 105, 28%. All for it. Let's roll. 87, 23.1%. Just changing again. Don't you just hate that? I'm strongly against it, 84, 22%. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 54. Let's take care of North Korea first, 35, and don't know, 12. 12 people are still looking on the map. Where's our Iraq? And isn't it the Iranians who live in Iraq?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, guys, you want a good excuse to sneak an extra night at the track on Thursdays and get the wife to come along, too? Then head on over to Pompano Parnas Harness Track. During the entire month of February, Pompano Park will be open on Thursday nights. Not only will they be open every Thursday, but in February it will be ladies' nights with two-for-one drink specials and free bingo for ladies, ladies only with more than $1,000 in cash and prizes. Let me say it again, free bingo for ladies only with more than $1,000 in cash and prizes. So Pompano Park is now open starting this week. Five nights a week, Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, first post time 7:15, free general parking, free admission every afternoon and night, and every Wednesday, like tonight, is dollar night at the track. You can get draft beer, hot dog soda, large pretzel or popcorn, only a buck apiece. Monday's Madness continues every Monday night, two for $25 full course dinner in their lavish top of the park restaurant on the sixth floor. And as far as racing is concerned, don't forget starting this Saturday, the opening round of the $250,000 Isle of Capri Pacing Series, featuring many of the best horses and drivers in North America racing right there at Pompano Park. Also this Saturday, free drawings to win a vacation package to Nassau in the Bahamas, including round trip airfare from Fort Lauderdale, and a 3-day stay at the Crystal Palace Hotel Casino. Pompano Park, where all of these things and lots more are going on, and don't forget full card simulcast testing every day starting at noon, too. Pompano Park, Powerline Road, a block south of Atlantic Boulevard.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Some people.
I'm walking across the street, I'm walking. Bitcoins on my feet, I'm schlepping to Shloimeh's kosher buffet. Oy vey, I'm waving my walking cane, I'm making the traffic great, I'm watching all the goyim stop for me. In an hour I'll get to the other side. I have some rigor mortis, but I still won't die. I have no teeth and my body's decayed, with varicose veins popping out of my legs. Still I'm walking in my jelly shoes. They're yelling, chew out the cockatoo. And I'm walking, chow cocks a hoist to you, you bastard you. I'm coming out your ass, you commissioned punk! Get out of here! I'm bucking his head with that kick!
Cut the crap, Mo. Just cut it out.
I can't stop.
10:45 at 560 WQM. So there's Colin Powell on there. Bop, 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 beep, 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 beep.
Destruction. And they can claim that nothing was there, and the inspectors can look all they want, and they will find nothing. This effort to hide things from the inspectors is not one or two isolated events. Quite the contrary. This is part and parcel of a policy of evasion and deception that goes back 12 years, a policy set at the highest levels of the Iraqi regime. We know that Saddam Hussein has what is called, quote, a higher committee for monitoring the inspection teams, unquote. Think about that. Iraq has a high-level committee to monitor the inspectors who were sent in to monitor Iraq's disarmament, not to cooperate with them, not to assist them, but to spy on them and keep them from doing their jobs. The committee reports directly to Saddam.
Do you realize how juvenile this is, how ridiculous it is?
Yeah, I do.
Is there any country in the world of any substance, of any significance, that we couldn't find weapons of what we would call mass destruction in?
Forbidden ammunition.
Right.
John
Rappaport writes, a few things to keep in mind when Powell addresses the UN to make the U.S. case for war against Iraq, which he's doing right now. Powell is being sent in to carry the water. He's done this before. He gives the impression of a man of great conscience, and then he takes his orders. That's his role. In the stage play, he's the good guy who ends up doing what everybody else does. He just agonizes beforehand. People think, hey, if Powell is on the team, they must be right because he was against them a few months ago. Sure, there are supermarkets on the sun, too. Meanwhile, Hans Blix has denied Powell's claims that the weapons inspectors are finding evidence of the Iraqis moving and hiding illicit materials. Blix says he's found no conclusive evidence that Iraqi weapons scientists have been taken out of the country to escape interviewers. Blix denies that Iraqi agents are pretending to be weapons scientists. He also denies that his weapons inspection team has been infiltrated by Iraqi agents. Bush, in the State of the Union message, asserted both of these claims. Blix also says he's seen no proof that Iraq and al-Qaeda are connected. Rumors are swirling of some smoking gun that's going to be carried out in the open by Powell or Bush at the last moment, before or during the address today, although he's already said he's not. They couldn't find one. An NSA intercept, a CIA document, a photo, whatever. Newsweek's already running, caught on tape. Hold your hat, we've got it. The only thing they did was run these transcripts a couple of minutes ago when he started speaking, where you got a couple of people speaking in Iraqi and Arabic, talking caca.
Right.
Well, they say something about Al Bundy? Yeah, that's what they said. They said Al Bundy did it. Powell will do one of these numbers. We didn't want to release this tape because it could cost the lives of our agents deep inside Iraq, but we flew these people out last night to a Sheraton hotel of their choice so we can tell the world what is really happening. Hello, George Orwell, it says. There you go. This is all part of the dog and pony show that's going on. I don't even know why they're wasting the time. They already got the troops over there. Bada-bing, just get it done. Okay, if you're going to do it, get it done.
It's a formality to make it look nice.
I see.
Wrap it up in a bow.
5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon line. I mean, I could put this on there, but...
All they possibly can.
But I don't think I want to, do you?
All the channels are carrying it.
Yeah. Anybody wants to see it, they can turn it on anywhere. In fact, even if you stick your finger in your pop-up toaster, you'll see Colin Powell on there going...
By sources.
Like that.
I feel really sorry for the fat shut-ins today.
Although I will tell you this, you know what he hasn't said yet?
Anthrax.
Hasn't said that yet.
How do you know?
I'm monitoring. I'm keeping one eye on it. WQAM.
Hi, Dr. Neil.
Speaking, sir.
Neil, how you doing?
Okay.
Listen, I don't mind your position on the war and so forth and so on.
Well, thank
but
you
I
so much.
Hello?
I said thank you so much. You don't
yes,
mind
but
that.
But at least you could not be so biased. Well, you quoted a little while ago a Washington Times article. You said it was ultra-conservative and so forth. And then you read a New York Times article, and you don't state the same thing. It's ultra-liberal. Be obvious. Be
obvious?
If you're going to say...
You don't understand.
If you're going to say...
I don't have to listen to your crap. If you're going to say, everybody knows out there New York Times has got a reputation as a very liberal, the ultra-liberal commie pinko newspaper. So what's the point? What's the difference? I have to draw you a diagram. If you're that stupid, what are you calling the show for? Giving me directions. If you're going to say this, if you're going to say that, I don't mind. Well, I don't really give a crap whether you mind or not, because I'm going to give my opinion in spite of your ass. How do you like that? In spite of your being a little punk with a tiny penis. What the hell do I care? God, I'm an old fag with a tiny penis. Never stop me from saying my opinion. 5670560, pound five. There you go, George. The only reason I mentioned the Washington Times is the point being that it's hardly a liberal, or that's always what we're getting thrown back at us. Well, you're reading stuff from all these liberal
right.
publications, and the Washington Times is anything but that.
You mentioned because it was an exception
right,
to what
exactly.
you're normally accused
that
of doing.
That is absolutely correct, sir.
And he's too stupid to.
Well, too stupid to understand it. He wouldn't know the Washington Times if they stuck 14 copies up his ass, and the print started coming out both ears.
But he doesn't mind your position.
Well, I'm delighted. I'm sitting in the prone position right now. I'm laying down. From those potato pancakes and that French toast. That sure was good. Thanks again to Corky's. But next time you send food over here, please understand, it wasn't Mo and Geldy that requested it. It was us, Neil and George and Carlos. Get it right. And the fact of the matter is that they wound up eating a big portion of that, and Robert Grieper was in there, and poor fat Zach. Oh, he needs that like he needs hemorrhoids, okay? Like he needs to have another gigantic oozing BM in there. And at the
hey, let him
company
pop up all
tea
the free food he can get while he can.
No way. No way. I'm going to tell you. One more free meal like that. Yeah, Carlos has got it right. He's given the blown up the cheeks routine. That's right. One more meal like that. He could blow up. Can you imagine the mess he's going to make in that control room?
Hey, he's
splattered
young.
All over the wall. Oh, what's that over there? Oh, it used to be Zach.
He probably doesn't have diabetes yet.
I'm telling you right now, mister, that man weighs 7,000 pounds stark naked in the shower in the morning. Oh, my God.
Thanks for coming.
They have to
up.
Dip him in Biscayne Bay in order to bathe all of him. Make sure they don't miss any spots. He's a good guy, but I'm telling you, he's just and all you do I'll say it again, every time I walk by that corner there, he's just shoveling it down and shoveling it down, shoveling it down. Where the hell's the rest of our food, by the way? How come we didn't get the brisket?
Maybe that's tomorrow.
See, what do you mean maybe that's tomorrow? Don't keep pushing for food on here, see?
I wasn't.
You're trying to do that again. You
were the one
that started that Corky's yesterday. Didn't he start
it? It was you.
And Carlos said you done it.
Say anything, he'll nod up and down.
Of course, because he knows there's nothing you can do for him.
Right.
Nothing. Nothing I'm going to do for him either, but at least he's hoping that maybe I'll get him like a little bit of a raise. Go to bat for him. Hey, I got news. Anybody that takes a bath in a sink, I'm not all that excited about that.
Go to bath for him.
Yeah. And in fact, I can just see it. He can share an apartment with Zach. And Zach can take like a bath in the whole apartment, and he can bathe in the sink.
Hey, that could be a sitcom.
Like in the Seaquarium. 5670560.
Come up with the additional four chemical weapon
shells. Satellite pictures here showing
here
Iraq hiding weapons.
Here you see 15 munitions bunkers in yellow and red outlines.
And there's Archie Bunker.
The four that are in red squares.
They're in the red square?
Active chemical munitions bunkers. How do I know that? How can I say that?
How do you know that?
Let me give you a closer look.
Okay.
Look at the image on the left. On the left is a close-up of one of the four chemical bunkers. The two arrows indicate the presence of sure signs
See, this whole thing is so ridiculous. The question isn't do they have this and do they have that. The question is how long have they had it, where do they get it, and are they really a danger to us? That's the question. Are we willing to jeopardize the lives of our servicemen and women, and are we willing to jeopardize the whole future of the planet based on the fact that they've got this? That's the question, is it not?
They're a danger to their own people, maybe their neighbors. That's it.
Yeah. And, of course, their neighbors are such good friends of ours, like the Saudis and Iran.
Uh-huh.
5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. WQAM.
Hey, thanks for taking my call.
Thanks for making your call, sir.
Amen. Hey, I just wanted to say that God forbid that a listener might have an opinion, and the fact that you won't even allow a listener to give out their opinion.
What do you mean by that?
It really doesn't matter, Neil, because quite honestly, stick to your poll because your show sucks anyways.
Well, why do you listen to it?
No, I'm just waiting
for you to
die.
Why do you listen to it? Why do you listen to it?
You're such a miserable. All you do is spread hatred,
yeah.
You miserable faggot.
Uh-huh. No, that's it. That was the end
of
it.
He was spreading love.
I see. There's another one of those right-wingers who can't handle the truth. All you do is spread hatred, you miserable faggot. Can't handle the truth, can you? You're another one of these assholes who wants anybody on here who will agree with you will parrot that la-da-da-da-da, that crap, another ditto head. But God forbid anybody should come on here and have an alternative point of view, and right away I'm a miserable. But you're listening. That's the best part. You're listening. You can tell everybody that nobody can have an alternative point of view. Did I hang up on him? No, he hung up on me. Even though he's making a scurrilous personal attack on me, didn't hang up on him. Hung up on the other punk because he was talking crap. He didn't know his ass from this guy's elbow. About the Washington Times, the New York Times, and you gotta say this. I don't have to do anything. I don't have to do anything. But sir, you're exactly what's wrong with America today. You're the reason why so many people are puking their guts out. Because they remember what this used to be. And now you and your ilk have turned this into a goose-stepping piece of turd is what this country is rapidly becoming. Where everybody has to like fall into line. Hey, the rest of the world, man, we've only got one superpower. We're going to show you a thing or two. And if you dare question our authority and our superiority, we're going to show you a thing or two. And he can't handle that. I'm not miserable at all, sir. I'm a pretty happy guy, you know, and even talking to assholes like you. Don't faze me in the least bit, okay? You're a dime a dozen. Dime a dozen. Why don't you go back to one of your right-wing websites and la-da-da-da-da and do your ditto head crap, okay? We don't want to interfere with your daily routine.
Go freep a pole.
Right. Go freep your ass. WQAM.
Hi, I'd like to speak with Neil, please.
Speaking.
Hi, Neil. I was just listening to your last two calls, and, you know, it's not about party line. It's like if you read, the imminent threat is North Korea. January 13th, U.S. Newsweek. People should pick it up and forget party line.
U.S. News and World Report?
Exactly. And there's eight pages, and then one page is devoted to what North Korea has versus Iraq. And it's like, you know, what good is it doing you to be saying this? I mean, you're trying to have people, you know, people to have an open mind and like, our most imminent threat is North Korea. And I just can't believe people are calling in. It's always about a party line.
Yeah.
And I just want to say, keep on, you know, telling people what's going on. People need to continue reading, and they need to forget about
party line. What do you mean continue reading?
Line.
They're not reading. They aren't reading.
I know they're not.
They're watching golf tournaments.
I know they're not. But, you know, there are people who listen to you, and there are people who read, and there are people who are not stupid. And, you know, every time I pick up.
Well, when do they start calling?
Well, I don't know. You know, I listen to you every day, and I read every article that I can because I don't want it to be a party line. I want what's good for America.
Okay.
And I just, you know.
Have a great day.
You too.
Here's a fact that says, had you been a Jew in Nazi Germany, you'd be making excuses for Hitler and making the case that the death camps are places where those in prison would have the leisure to reflect on their slander against the Third Reich. What?
Huh?
Exactly. Exactly. Don't ask me. Who the hell knows? They're all coming out now, man. They're rattling their sabers. They're getting their spears all geared up. They're getting their Albert spears all whipped up. Oh, thank you so much. There's the Smallville post, and I'll throw it away. Poster from Smallville, small potatoes. See that? My mind must have told me. Yeah. Forget about that.
We could stick it up on a wall if you want.
Go ahead and stick it. 10:57 at 5:60. Colin Powell is saying,
announced publicly and announced ominously.
Meanwhile, speaking of ominous, I'll tell you that fat, that big, heavy load that the beast was carrying around, thank goodness he's starting to look almost human these days. And see what I just said about big, fat load, and look who walks in the door, fat boy. Anyway, if you're a big, fat tub, like, Oh, my God.
You're going
to
die.
You have to be joking me. Corky's just showed up with more food. Wow. Maybe that food was for Moe and Gildy, although they didn't know anything about it. At any rate, let me tell you about Balance for Life. You don't have to be a fat pig like me or like the Beast. If you're one of those people who is fat right now but doesn't enjoy being fat, if you'd like to lose that weight and you want to get healthy and look great, here's the answer. Balance for Life. No cooking, no shopping, no cleaning, no worries, no calorie counting, no carbohydrate counting. No matter which program that you've been trying to follow, if you failed, it's probably because they're too complicated. You go into the supermarket, you have no idea what to buy. With Balance for Life, you don't do any shopping because they provide all the food in your little black sack, which they deliver right to your door every morning. Three gourmet meals, two delicious snacks, five meals, plenty of food to keep you full all day long, and it's all geared to the principles of the Zone Diet. It really works. It's delicious. There's nothing frozen, nothing artificial. All you have to choose is between two choices for each meal every day that you're on the program. The Beast has lost, like, what is it? About 50 pounds, and we're going to get him under 200 pounds before the end of this year. It's guaranteed. You can do the same. Call Balance for Life. Do it the simple, delicious way. 954-568-3229. 954-568-3229, or visit their website at balanceforlife.com.
My and local. This is Sports Radio 560. QAM.
Hi, I am not a Nazi.
Blinded by the rhyme, bamboozled by douchebags, the pasty moral rhyme. Blinded by the rhyme, I felt like a douchebag, cause I knew they were a rhyme. I know you may not understand what I did or who I am. Most of you don't read any books, so let me introduce myself. I was a well-respected, hard-right man, entrusted by high-level schnooks. I used to have a powerful Republican position, high up on a moral ground. The holy Christians were insisting that I discredit Clinton with any means that could be found. Since then I had a nervous breakdown, cause I was blinded by the right. Bamboozled by douchebags, the moral pasty ride. Blinded by the ride, I felt like a douchebag, cause I knew they were right. I had admission to the party thrown by moralistic Christians, and crawling there naked on the rug. Was anorexic, pundit, sister, and culture raising blisters, giving power balls a tug. My job was to alter news to a right-wing point of view. Evil minds are easy to sway. And now the hatred that I spewed about minorities and banker Jews make me want to puke today.
You asshole!
I couldn't even say I was gay, cause I was blinded by the right. Bamboozled by douchebags, the pasty moral right. Blinded by the right. There was Ann Coulter, she was naked on all fours with two guys taking her doggy style.
You asshole!
1104 at 560 WQM. That caller, he was great. You know, if we could just get 20 like him every day. You know, he's got no arguments. He's got no case to make. He's got nothing to say. It's just, you don't let anybody else say anything anyway, and you faggot, and you're just miserable, and
hate-filled faggot.
Hate-filled spewing. He's the hate. Spewing.
His love.
Spewing his love. But luckily, right after he got on here, we got Corky's came in again. Message here, it says to Neil Rogers, thanks for the plug, enjoy the goodies. Seymour, our good friend at Corky's 671 North Palm Avenue, Pembroke Pines. And we got Reuben sandwich, which I'm having a half of one, and more potato pancakes, and some delicious brisket sandwiches on the beautiful little rolls. In fact, Carlos went out there, he said, it's my first brisket. Try to explain to me, you only get bris once, at least most of us. I think in my case there may have been, like two or three.
You
have
to go back again.
Anyway, too late. They can't tie one on. So anyway, there we go. One of our and the fax is coming in. They can't stand the fact that I'm still on the air. That there are a handful of us on the air who aren't goose stepping the party line, because people like that. What they want is everybody in this country who's anywhere in the media. These are the same people who are bellyaching about the liberal bias in the media. They want everybody to be a goose stepper. Now, what kind of a country is that?
Their kind of
what
country.
Kind, exactly. Very well said. Let's take a look at the poll and see. Maybe he's right. Don't forget, noon to one, our comedy hour today, which means we can really indulge in lunch in that hour. I'm just practicing now. not to roll me out of here in a wheelbarrow, but wasn't that something? Do you see who was there at the door to let our friend from Corky's in?
Yeah, how apropos.
Fat Boy, a.k.a. Jeff High, a.k.a. the guy with a chronic neighbor.
Is he back on his walker again?
Yeah. You didn't see that? Walker, cane, whatever the hell it was, he was just barely moving.
He's got a TV tray attached to his walker.
Yeah, well, you ought to see how much food really showed up. Well, we got what's left on the tray. That's only what he left for us. I guarantee you, you multiply that times five, and you see what's on his desk back there in the sales office. And the formerly full sales, want to be a sales hole here? If you're obsessed with sports. 477 votes. What's your take on war with Iraq?
In the year 2000.
Well, no, I think it's a little late for that now. Well, he's confused. He's like living in the past. He's a little reactionary now. They've gotten to him. What's your take with a war on Iraq? 483 votes now. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 133. Strongly against it, 122. So right there is 52.7%. All for it. Let's roll! 108, 22.3%. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 63, 13%. Let's take care of North Korea first, 41, 8.4%. Don't know, 16, 3.3%. So if you combine all for it, let's roll, and I support it, but I'm nervous about it, and give them the benefit of the doubt, that's 35%. So at 65 to 35, you know what the national polls have all been showing the last few days?
I give up.
Two-thirds opposed, 66 to 33.
Oh, that's
and
just
our poll,
a liberal
and our
spin.
Our poll's almost exactly the same. When they asked the poll on CNN, was it 2 weeks ago that I told you about who do they agree with, whose position they agree with more on Iraq, Ted Kennedy or President
right.
Bush? 75% agreed with Kennedy and 25% Bush. Now, we certainly know in this country, 75% of the public is very, very far politically from Ted Kennedy. Very, very far. But on that particular issue was 3-1.
You're just slanting the poll, you hateful faggot.
Are you miserable little spick? And by the way, speaking of people who are dangerous and have people tortured and in jail and in death camps and whatever else, how about good old Fidel down there? I don't see us getting ready to invade Cuba.
How much oil's he got?
None.
Well, there you are.
Okay. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless Line. WQAM.
Yeah, I'd like to talk about North Korea for a second.
Yes, sir. Go right ahead.
Before I talk about that, I understand you did a poll yesterday.
Oh, it's Reverend Jones again. Get out of here. We'd stick North Korea up your ass. In fact, you're the first one we're going to send over there. We're going to send you right over to Kim Il-chung.
Human bombs, if it's good
mm-hmm.
enough for
them. Right. He's got a human bomb, Reverend Jones.
Oh, look, cartoon graphics of the weapons that they might have.
As these drawings, based on their description,
show. The drawings.
Yeah, these drawings. Here's some pictures for you, okay? Here he is at the United Nations. Here's some pictures, some drawings we made. Are they entertaining? They're in full color.
Pretty.
5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T and Verizon line. WQAM.
Booga, booga.
Here's our last call on screenless. They all must be transfixed with colon. WQAM. Hello. WQAM.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yes.
Yeah, you think you can bite my balls?
567. Next time, try
That's
to get your
I
ass
love
out of the
screenless.
Yeah. Hey, well, listen. What difference does it make? Do I have any choices? There's nobody on the phone. They're all busy watching Colin Powell. So we'll eat and we'll wait for you to decide you want to talk to us. Isn't that a good idea?
Bits hour early.
Hmm? Maybe we should do that. We don't have a call on the board on screenless, which is unheard of in the history of the show, which shows you how very important this is. First-hand information of biological weapons plants on wheels. See that? And there's a drawing of one.
It goes with their meals on wheels.
Hmm.
How long do you think it will take the inspectors to find even one of these 18 trucks without Iraq coming forward as they are supposed to? With the information
hey,
about
give us
these
the evidence that we need to go to war against
capabilities.
You.
Yeah, exactly. WQAM.
Hey, good morning, Neil. How are you?
I'm okay.
Hopefully I'll be a little
for
more
a hateful old faggot,
that.
I'm okay.
Hey, listen, maybe I'm just a little fearful of war in general, but isn't Venezuela kind of a threat, too? I mean, think of it. They've got oil and they've got gold, and they're, you know, in the same hemisphere as us.
And a banana republic to top it all off?
Yeah, aren't they kind of a potential risk? I mean, how do you pick and choose who you go blow up?
Well, Castro is only 90 miles away from where we're sitting right now, and he's certainly a threat.
Yeah, but he's a lack of resources. Unless he figures out a way to catapult bananas 90 miles, you know.
How do we know he gave all those nukes back during the missile crisis?
Yeah. How do we know that he doesn't have biological weapons? Because
hidden bunkers,
there are those people
baby.
Who believe that he does.
Yeah, I know. I So how do any of us sleep at night? I mean,
well,
you know,
let me say it like I said yesterday. The Soviet Union had just as many when there was a Soviet Union, just as many nuclear weapons as we did when an arms race was going on during the Cold War. And yet somehow we're still here today, which means we somehow found a way, even dealing with crazy people, to coexist. Because peaceful coexistence, as namby-pamby as it may sound, that's the only way the planet's going to keep spinning around. I hate to break the news to all these hawks out there, all these people that are rattling their spears and want to make themselves feel macho. That's the only way we're going to exist.
Well, I'm sorry. Maybe I'm jaded because I'm getting up in years like you. But you know what? It seems like the saber rattling always intensifies around the election, and then it dies down. I'm sorry. I've never bought this whole thing. I think he's trying to fix what his daddy didn't take care of a long time ago. And I think daddy started it back then because of the election, too. I just don't buy the whole thing.
Well, it sure didn't work out too good, did it?
No, it sure didn't. Okay. I guess, like most Bushes, he doesn't know how to finish.
Get under the bed. We'll let you know when it's safe to come out.
That's right.
Okay. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon Wireless line. It's 11 after 11 at 560 WQM. You know, guys, size does matter. And according to the Florida Department of Labor, computer professionals have really big ones. We're talking about paychecks. According to the state of Florida, computer careers are among the highest paid and the highest demand. And FastRank can help you achieve your new high-paying computer career. That's the underlying part. High-paying computer career in just 4 short months. Fast Train's got locations in Kendall, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, Pembroke Pines. With day, evening, and weekend schedules, there's no excuse to stay in your current crappy dead-end job. So if you really, and if you don't want to come to work here at QIM selling, if you're not a sports nut, here's the answer for you. Call Fast Train, get a real job. Call 1-866-FAST-TRAIN. That's 1-866-FAST-TRAIN. They got full-time job placement, guaranteed financing waiting for you too. Call them today or check them out on the web at fasttrain.com because you too can have a big fat paycheck. 1-866-FAST-TRAIN. Train.
Live and local. This is 560.
The radio's all yours now.
QAM.
Beware of exploding balls.
Tonight, I think that you might see a side of me you ain't seen before. Gonna eat till I'm full, get real comfortable, then let something sneak out my back door. You will beg for mercy and drop to your knees. Roll down all the windows, cause I'm about to cut the cheese. Went to Taco Bell, my tummy don't feel too well. Now something's gonna smell like hell. Tonight you're gonna smell mine. We're in a relationship, so go on and take a sniff, cause I'm about to let one rip. Cause tonight you're gonna smell mine. There's more where that came from, I hope it ain't a problem. There's something coming out of mine, cause you're about to smell mine.
11:16 at 560 WQM. Wally in Deerfield writes a long fax here, and at the end he says, "Mailman just delivered my latest purchase from Amazon.com, Gore Vidal's Dreaming War, Blood for Oil, and the Cheney Bush Junta." Ought to take about 3 hours to read. Lynn Samuels emailed me yesterday from Vegas, where she's hanging out, and said this book is even better than the David Brock book, Blinded by the Right. So I'm going to go out and buy it, like, in the next couple of days. Dreaming War, Blood for Oil, and the Cheney Bush Junta by Gore Vidal. Oh, yeah, well, we know about him. He's not, yeah, exactly. Too bad he can't be as smart as some of these people we talk to every day, huh? Behind the anonymity of their stupid-ass phone. That guy was classic. He was perfect. He's what America, unfortunately, is becoming more and more every minute of every day. That guy. And all of his ditto heads.
I can't believe that. I think it's that right-wing media portraying it that way.
I see. Right.
They're not showing the protests.
By the way, thanks again to Corky's for a great lunch. My blood sugar ought to be about, what, 6:30 by about now? 4:50?
Is that like char-broiled brisket?
What do you mean?
They have on there?
I haven't had any of the brisket yet. Of course, when we get to our noon to what comedy bits are, you never know. I might have a little. Now, see, by putting that all out there, that guarantees that all the brisket's going to disappear. And if I don't have at least one of those little briskets, I'm going to be really pissed off. Carlos?
We're going to retrieve it.
Yeah. He looks like a retriever. Now, take that back. That's an insult to my dogs.
Oh, you didn't say a golden retriever.
Oh. WQAM.
How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Hey, all this, Neil, is just a bunch of propaganda to change the subject. We're in serious economic trouble with all the trade agreements with NAFTA and GATT and so on, a $500 billion trade deficit. For the next 2 years, whether it's the Democrats or the Republicans, they're going to be giving rattling the saber to change the subject because we're going into a severe recession, depression, and this is about changing the subject.
And what happens if Saddam decides, if he's got his back to his wall, he decides to have an incendiary event in all the Iraqi oil fields, which they feel that he's already planted
explosives
in all the oil fields there, at least there are 2,000 of them.
Yeah, well, this is possible, but it's over 80-90% of our people do not trust our government and our government and media.
But, I mean, what's going to happen to the economy if he does that and the world oil supply?
Well, I think there's a serious problem with that, but that's not going to take the economy down. With all these trade agreements, we're in big, big trouble, and they're going to use the Iraqi just as they used the 9/11 to blame the economy on it. We're going to into a depression, and they're going to use 9/11 and Iraq and or North Korea as an excuse for this recession depression.
Well, remember what happened with trickle-down economics the first time in the early 80s under Reagan that they all rave about. Gave us another recession depression, same thing, because it doesn't work. It's as George Bush said, the senior, Herbert Walker, voodoo economics. Remember he called it that when he ran against Reagan?
Yeah, but you're missing the big picture. When we have all these trade agreements with Mexico and China, this was a Democrat, Clinton and Gore, and a Republican Congress that gave it to us. Both parties gave it to us.
Amen. Because they both suck.
Thank you.
And have a great day.
You too.
Oh, but Neil, you're so partisan. Yeah, I think they both suck. That's how partisan I am. How many years have I been saying that? That the Democratic Party is only useful for one thing, and that is being a buffer. But as far as being productive or being positive, forget about it. Forget about it, because most of them are controlled by the same special interest to control the Republicans. Phil says, I admire your ability to not get so emotional about political issues. I listen to both sides of the Iraq issue, and I'm amazed how hysterical the right-wingers get. They're the poster children for hypocrisy, as evident by your recent callers. I've been listening to Colonoscopy Powell nip and tuck at the most inconsequential BS and lame attempt to legitimize Georgie's war plans, and two want to hurl chunks. He wants to hurl chunks, this guy. How do you like that? There's one for you. And to make matters worse, I'm sitting at work being force-fed this swill by four radios turned to colon bowel, says Phil. Oh, my God. Well, we're not going to do that to you, Phil. That's it. That was enough.
You look at the French guy. He's got his pursed lips like he's not buying any of this.
I see. Well, you know those French, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Like that one other lunatic we had. Well, let's drop bombs on France, and we'll take
care
of Germany. Let's just start WW3 to make some of these macho guys feel better. That's time to go to their VFW meeting, if it's still there.
VFW3?
Yeah. How come they're faxing me the stuff that we've already got on our website about Michael Jackson? The Scotsman, police scrutinized Jackson documentary. The district attorney of Santa Barbara County, California, is to scrutinize the documentary in which Michael Jackson admitted inviting young children to sleep in his bed in case Martin Bashir's program can be used to open the door to new prosecution. They're going to be watching with eagle eye when it's on ABC tomorrow night. Forget about that program tomorrow night. Worry a lot more about the show that's on ABC a week from tomorrow night. Next Thursday, the 13th of February.
What's that?
What a short memory he's got, huh? It's these hot bodies.
Oh, the hot, the hard.
They always have to leave it up to me. Mr. Sexpot in here. Mr. Hotshot, strip club, swing club, all this other stuff. And I'm the one that had to, like, invent Britney Spears for him that he never heard of. And I'm also the one that's got to turn him on to this Are You Hot on ABC.
Or remember all that.
The Search for America's Sexiest People next Thursday, February 18th, 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central. Mark it on the calendar. He's marking it down right now. Next Thursday, the 13th of February. There you go. Where am I reading this? Which, in the Inquirer, no less. They got big full-page color ads in every paper. And they only show these people, guy and a chick here, with their from the neck down. And that's all you need to see, from the chin down. Take a look at the melons. She might as well be stark naked, huh?
Okay.
Am I pretty close?
She's close.
I'll guarantee you one thing. She had to use her Bic before they took this picture. She's got on a bikini about the size of your thumb.
They use wax now.
And as far as he's concerned, I'll tell you one thing. If he looks as good from the chin up as he does from the chin down, look out. Next Thursday, February 13, as ABC finally discovers America wants to see hot, good-looking people as opposed to most of these ugly people that they put on these dating shows, these so-called reality shows. Nobody wants to really see that. They're watching it only because there's nothing else on. And the fact of the matter is that network TV is in the crapper because now and now more people have more and more choices. 80 billion channels, real digital cable, which most of us don't have here, but in most places, real digital cable, satellite dishes, DirecTV, Dish TV, all kinds of crap. How do you like that? DVDs, BVDs. That's what we want to see. Tom Brady and his BBDs. So what was that, Guiding Shiite? What time is that on? 5670560.
I think we're watching it now.
Yeah, we're watching lots of Shiite right now, I'll tell you that.
Have more than a decade of proof.
Yeah, okay, good. Well, where is it? Where is it, Cole Roland Colon? We want to see it, we want to hear it, we want to feel it, we want to squeeze it. Prove this. I mean, this, you know, it's like saying, you know, here's the proof, and whether you believe it or not, we're going to go in anyway. So what's the point? Another dog and pony show, just like they did with airport security. Remember I kept talking it was a dog and pony show?
Oh, the
and they keep finding box
guard.
Cutters. They keep finding box cutters in the seat pockets in front of the seats. All this other crap that they keep going on. The National Guard were standing there to make us feel safe. Were we safe?
No.
No. We're just lucky as hell we haven't had more crap going on yet.
Yet.
And it seems to me, and of course, don't forget, it was George Tenet, the director of the CIA, who said, it's going to happen. Not a question of if, it's just a question of when. It's going to happen. It's going to be bad. And we're going to take all of these resources. We got all of these troops over there in the Middle East again for war on Iraq. While we're reading at the same time that Al-Qaeda is like reorganizing.
Are we done in Afghanistan, by the way? We don't have
hell
any
no.
Are
oh,
we just,
oh,
really?
And let me say this to you, too, at the risk of sounding insensitive, because it pisses me off, okay? Because as far as I'm concerned, one American life is just as valuable, one human life is just as valuable as anybody else's. And how about all the American troops that have lost their lives over there in Afghanistan and in Kuwait, who are getting shot and killed by these barbarians almost every day? How come we don't see them on television and hear all of their names and about their families and who the hell they were?
Right.
And since we don't have the draft, all of them obviously volunteered to serve their country, so they're obviously heroes. How come we don't hear a hell of a lot more about them? I'm not trying to downplay the, you know, the sadness of the thing with the astronauts who had to be human sacrifices too because NASA didn't have the funding to do the proper things in the space shuttle, and now more and more that's kind of like leaking out, like the article we started the show with today. They were human sacrifice, just like the school teacher and that crew on the Challenger. Scientists begged them, warned them, the O-rings, if they get too cold, if they're out there in freezing temperatures, it's tremendous danger. There's a good chance that the thing will blow up. Guess what? They left it because of the timing. They had to get it done for the State of the Union address. Oh, is that the one with the school teacher? Mommy? 5670560. Very, very sad. Very sad how few people can think for themselves in this country. Oh. And if somebody says, oh, look at
the
that.
Tube.
What is that? Oh, there's a tube.
No. That there are differences of opinion. There is controversy about what these tubes are for.
Well, yeah, and of course you don't know what the hell they're for, and you're about the only one, you and your henchmen.
You know, I could make a bong with that thing that would just
a bong?
Blow your brains
see,
out.
See, there you go again. Anybody want to buy some drugs from George? He's got a sale on this week because times
sell,
are getting tough.
Sell some drugs to George.
Carlos just raised his hand. He said he'll buy from you. He don't do it on credit, okay, Carlos? And he also doesn't take checks, at least not your checks. 26 past 11. Thank God we got that big noon at 1 hour coming. See, didn't I tell you? I'm no fool. I knew that today was the day to get
that bookend idea that I had. Nice tight 2 hours in the middle.
Starting tomorrow, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be here between 9 and 10, play comedy bits for an hour. Then I'm going to let George do 10 to noon, and then I'm going to come back from a nice leisurely brunch, and I'll play comedy bits noon to 1. How do you like that, Tom Jicka?
Oh!
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Well, you got to read a couple bedtime stories.
No.
While you're on.
I'll tape them.
Okay.
By the way, speaking of bedtime, what a nice segue. Are you sleeping on a crappy old mattress? Well, the answer is don't do it anymore because you're going to feel like crap. Your mattress has a lot to do with your whole physical being and the way you feel. If you don't get a good night's sleep, you feel like crap. Take it from me. Do the smart thing. Call Dial-A-Mattress. Just sit there on your big, fat, lazy ass. Make one easy call to 1-800-MATTRESS, and that's all you have to do. They've got the best mattresses in the world. Sealy, Serta, Simmons, King Coil, every size and style under the sun. Some places make you sleep on your new mattress 30 to 60 nights before you can even exchange it. Not at Dial-A-Mattress. You've got 30 days to try it out. Their 30-day comfort exchange policy. No hassles at all. It's unparalleled in the universe, just like their delivery policy. They deliver any day, 7 days a week in the two-hour window that you choose when it's convenient for you and you know you're going to be home instead of wasting a day of your life sitting on your ass praying that somebody shows up. You can't beat it all the way around, and especially their everyday low prices, too. So if you want to sleep in comfort tonight and every night, call Dial-A-Mattress right now. They'll be there as soon as today. Call 1-800-MATTRESS, 1-800-M-A-T-T-R-E-S for Dial-A-Mattress, the answer for a perfect night's sleep.
We're Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Holy Mackinac! This is Joe Bowen, the voice of the Toronto Maple Leafs, and you're listening to the Hockey Authority, Neil Gott.
If anybody has a
opinion, dissenting from our way. We'll place your name into the system, an enemy of the state. Don't even bother to question, just follow and obey. Everybody's turning fascist, fascist USA. In the act of patriotism, we're watching all of you. Everyone's under suspicion, so that's what you do. They've got information on all you mindless fools. In Bush fatherland nation, fascist USA. You gotta hate those Jews,
yeah.
And Clinton liberals too. Believe everything we tell you on the state-run news. Blood war and for corporate, fill up your Escalade. A Reuben Cheney Bush venue, fascist USA. We don't mind to see our jobs go, a bad economy's good. We're fascinated by J-Lo. Don't read no stupid books. All now are embracing the facts of American way. Everybody's turning fascist. Fascist USA.
Love the 33 of 560 WQM. Am I onto them or am I onto them, huh?
Yeah.
What did I say to you before I checked out their website, freerepublic.com? I said, looks like the Freepers are on our poll all of a sudden because all of a sudden, right to the top went, I'm all for war with Iraq, let's roll. And I mean, it just, it doesn't happen that way, it doesn't work. We've been doing these too long. And so I click on freerepublic.com.
Did you say freerepublic.com?
Freerepublic.com. I hop right in where it says they're on their homepage, on their front page. And I hop right in, and about halfway down on the first page, Neil Rogers, which they can't even spell right. Can you get it right? There's no D in my name, okay? D is in dumb and dangerous and paranoid. Isn't paranoid at the end of with a D? Yes. Neil Rogers poll, let's freep it. And then they got our website, et cetera, and so on, and with three comments. Let's see what the comments are, okay? So what we're going to have to do, Eric, is we're going to have to put commentary to disqualify. You might want to put some note on our website that we're aware of the fact that freerepublic.com is freeping and distorting our poll today. He's freeped this poll. He's ripping Bush today. Oh! Let's see. Anything else? Freep this poll. Yada, yada, yada. Am I the only one who hasn't heard of Neil Rogers? Says somebody. Well, at least, and this guy spelled it right.
He hasn't heard of you, but he got it.
Says, Neil rips W each and every day. What a shock. He's funny about once every 3 weeks. Oh. Well, that's good. I'll let you know what day that's going to be. Duly freep, but it needs help, writes somebody else. As the freepers are organizing, they're going to get all their right-wingers, and they're going to get together, and they're going to vote, and they're going to vote. And you know what? Disqualify. Anytime we can discover that our poll is being distorted and freeped by people extremists of any ilk, no matter what the issue is, they're disqualified. Okay? So cut the crap. You're just wasting your time. FreeRepublic.com. All you freepers. Creeper, freeper. Jeepers, creepers. I think it's the freepers.
Hey, Buck O'Brien.
Yeah, there's a good bit for you. Cheapers, creepers, we're getting the freepers. And they're just barely in first place, by the way. So everybody else vote 10 times. Everybody else who doesn't agree with this. This is so sad. Like I said, it's like a bunch of little children. They have to alert each other that there's actually somebody on there giving an alternate point of view.
As if.
I mean, what impact have we got? And people are coming on here and voting who don't even know who the hell I am. Don't know me from a banana. Much less have any idea what this show is all about.
Well, you are looking a little jaundiced lately.
Yeah, I feel a little jaundiced.
About using such devices.
Well, maybe that's what did it. Huh? Maybe I had it too deep in my...
Rectum.
I don't know. 608 votes. What's your take on War with Iraq? I'm all for it. Let's roll. 163, 26.8%. But, better put that warning up on there, Eric, the one about how every vote down there is helping fund our gay agenda. So they're in a real catch-22. They're really boxed in here on this thing now. Every time they log on there, every time we get another hit on that website, it's helping to fund our, what Eric calls our gay agenda.
Cha-ching.
Yeah. All for it, let's roll, 163. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 151. Strongly against it, 146. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 83. Let's take care of North Korea first.
All right.
48. And don't know, 17. Boy, oh boy, I'm telling you, it's scary what's going on with this country today. Just scary. I mean, you know, polls are polls. They don't have all that much significance. But this paranoid Neanderthal group of right-wingers, man, everything has got to be just according to Hoyle. And nobody can say this. And nobody can talk about Condoleezza. And certainly nobody can criticize Colin Powell. And nobody can criticize W. or Rumsfeld or Cheney or any of these people. Now, when did we... Is that part of the USA Patriot Act? Does it say that in there?
Yes.
Oh. Is that kind of when we rolled back the First Amendment?
It's part of that manifesto that nobody seems to want to talk about.
The right-wing manifesto. I forgot about that. And you know what else I forgot to wear to work this morning? My hip boots.
I wore mine.
Oh, there it is. Eric has put them on notice. Please feel free to freep our pool. The proceeds help to fund our gay agenda. A real dilemma, isn't it? Or as we say north of the border, a real dilemma, eh?
Like,
oh, speaking of that, Maple Leafs here tonight.
Oh!
Hey, a little message for Pat Quinn, okay? I know you guys, you're down here for a few days, the All-Star break. Probably played a lot of golf. And maybe show up tonight would be good, okay? It would be very nice if you actually showed up and played a game, as opposed to what often happens, you know? Get lulled in like, we're not really into it. Just go through the motions. We don't want to see that, okay, us Maple Leaf fans. We want to see a real ass-kicking game tonight. And we don't want to see no Trevor Kidd in there. We want Eddie the Beagle in there tonight, okay? I just mentioned that in passing, Pat. Maybe my friends Joe and Harry will pass that along to you. Certainly not Rimmer. He's probably getting a free lunch right now. So the Freepers are they're on our case again today. Isn't that a shame? Don't you feel like,
unclean?
He's ripping Bush today. Oh, my God. I wonder how come we played all those Bill Clinton parodies, they never got excited about that.
Oh, they got excited, but all right.
At least they admit I'm funny about once every 3 weeks. Well, that's good.
Could you put that on the calendar for us?
March 15th, right around the Ides of March.
Did you say March?
Yeah, March right down the Hershey Highway. 22 till noon, Colin Powell still going bop, 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 bop.
On Baghdad.
Yeah, bop, 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 bop. He's still marching on bag. He's got the bag, Dad. Hey, I'll tell you a place where they got the great food, and that's Flores Pizza. They've been there about 700 years. While almost every other business in that neck of the woods has gone bye-bye, and we did all that talk about that, it's just amazing how many businesses have come and gone. There was Junior's, like, across the street, and there was, like, all Sonny's Market. All of those things. And most of them are just gone. But Flores is still there, and the food is better than ever. Nothing comes out of the can. It's all fresh, and you'll taste the difference when you pop it in your puss. The freshly made dough, the sauce, the freshly baked garlic rolls, which they bake right there every day at Flores. The portions are gigantic, and they use more cheese and meats on their pies than anyone in town. I love it when that cheese is oozing all over the place. You'll be fighting for that last slice of pizza if it's from Flores. Don't take our word for it. Find out for yourself. Go to 731 Northeast 79th Street, just off Biscayne Boulevard. That's 79th, just a couple of streets east, blocks east of Biscayne, right? Well, we haven't been there in so long. I mean, I remember the bridge tender. Or call Flores at 305-758-5351. That's 305-758-5351, and they'll deliver for you. They'll deliver from 34th and Biscayne all the way to 135th and Biscayne. They'll go to Quayside, the Cricket Club, the Jockey Club. Flores even delivers as far west as 12th Avenue and east to Collins and 71st. If you're nice to little Judy when you call, by the way, she'll tell you about the great pizza specials, like $13.99 for a large cheese pie, liter of soda, and six delicious chicken wings, all of these things, only $13.99. Call Flores or some of the best chow in Dade County. Call 305-758-5351, 305-758-5351, and tell them that Fat Neil told you to call.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAM.
You fudge packer?
Remember all those happy days, those sunny days of just 3 years ago.
Yes.
All my stocks just kept on rising, and I kept on fantasizing about that show. Then along came number 43, just like that my stocks began to slide. I don't like to throw no blame around, but it looks like Georgie took me for a ride. Sing GW's Bushonomics, surprise side economic blues.
you feel good from your head down to the holes in your shoes. Join your friends and neighbors, hell, you ain't got nothing to lose. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues. And how about those folks at Enron? Man, they really took a hit big time. And we won't forget those accounting guys, what they did with the numbers, it's a crime. And all those other companies left all their employees high and dry. It just ain't the good old American way. It almost makes a grown man want to cry. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues. Guaranteed to make you feel good from your head down to the holes in your shoes. Join your friends and neighbors. You ain't got nothing to lose.
Loan me $50.
GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues.
Me estoy muriendo aquí.
And those $1 billion dividend tax cut proposals, that's a stretch. With a $10 trillion economy, please somebody tell me what's the catch. If you talk about the real world, you'd have to say old George ain't got a clue. No way. Let's just send him back to Texas for this trickle-down economic blues. Bye-bye, George. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply-side economic blues.
Bye-bye-bye!
Guaranteed to make you feel good from your head down to the holes in your shoes. Yeah! Join your friends and neighbors. Hell, you ain't got nothing to lose. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues.
Come on, America, let's all sing.
Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues.
I'm dying over here.
Guaranteed to make you feel good from your head down to the holes in your shoes. Yeah! Join your friends and neighbors. Hell, you ain't got nothing to lose. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues. Sing GW's Bushonomics, supply side economic blues.
And like I said, it was Daddy George Herbert Walker Bush,
M-O-R-O-N,
who called that supply side economics, that trickle down theory, voodoo economics. Remember that?
I remember.
Just like it was only 10 years ago, 20 years ago.
Ronnie doesn't, I do.
5670560, #560 on the AT&T and Verizon line. The freepers at freerepublic.com are working not so feverishly anymore, I guess. Maybe they're trying to get their spelling right to show you what a bunch of rocket scientists they are. They put the big red headline there on the stories that you should really breathlessly look at. Let's freep this poll. Neil Rogers with a D, which of course is misspelled. Even Roy and Dale know that. And then if you look beneath it where they've got the link to the website, there's the correct spelling of the website. Because
well,
otherwise it wouldn't go there.
Job, you know.
Yeah. I understand that, but it
I know.
Oh, boy. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T line. And Colin Powell is still rolling, Colin.
It should be a subject of deep and continuing concern.
Good. WQAM. WQAM.
My balls are blue.
WQAM.
Jamba.
Okay, they're all out today in force. WQAM.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
Okay.
Hey, I have a concern, and the concern is that your show is turning more into the Randy Rhoads show.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Oh, and that's the end of the conversation. Huh?
I think that was him again.
I see. See, you know what really gets me? And you people are as transparent as a pane of glass. When I was doing the bedtime stories, and you remember this business we used to discuss whether the audience liked it, they didn't like it. No, don't do this. It's too political, and you're too critical of the president. And all that is a not even thinly veiled, a totally unveiled, a naked attempt to try to dissuade me from expressing an alternative point of view. This ain't the Randy Rhoads Show. We got more people listening in 5 minutes than she's had ever since she's been on the air put together, okay? Who are you kidding? This isn't light bulb radio, and that's what disturbs you. And if it's turning into something you don't like, anybody with a brain would turn it off. That's all you're trying to do, is do everything in your power. If you can't get me off the air, which you can't and won't, if you can't do that, try to make him go back just to being a simpleton. Well, you know, we're trying to do a balance like we always have. A lot of fun, a lot of funny stuff, give people a few laughs, but also have something to say. Something different from the same swill, the same repetitious, la-da-da-da-da, ditto-head crap that you hear nonstop 24 hours a day, round the clock at every station in America. And if you think that has any impact on us, blow it out your ass. It doesn't. It has no impact on anybody. They're like a bunch of naked people running up and down the street. WQAM.
Yeah, can I have a request,
please? WQAM.
Hey, Stubby.
WQAM.
Great balls of fire.
WQAM.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
As far as the Iraq situation is concerned, you know, with all due respect to your opinion, we just can't, the United States, we can't sit around and wait for the inspectors to go around going from place to place to find these things. The Middle East hates us, no matter what we do.
Yeah.
If we restrain from doing it, if we do what we're going to do, they're still going to hate us just as much, a little bit more.
Well, let me ask you this. Wait a minute. The Middle East hates us, and what's the rest of that?
Well, the Middle East hates us, so no matter what we do...
So in other words, if we go in there and start dropping bombs on Iraq, the Middle East is going to like us a lot?
It doesn't matter. There's no compromise with those people.
So let me say this. Assuming your argument is correct, okay?
Okay.
Assuming you're absolutely right for the sake of argument,
all right,
then why should we risk the lives of all of those thousands and thousands of military people, those young people, Americans, and all the millions of people over there with whom we have no quarrel? The people in Baghdad aren't our enemies.
Well, we don't know that for sure.
We don't know that for sure, so what should we do? Kill all of them?
Wipe them out.
I've got a better idea. No, that was a great concept. We don't know for sure who which people are the enemy. So let's just kill everybody else.
Let God sort them out.
Let God sort it out. We got all those nukes. They're just sitting there gathering dust. Let's just use them all, okay? If you don't use it, you lose it. And let's carry this imperialistic thing to the ultimate. Let's just blow up the whole world, kill everybody else.
That's a good reason to go to war, too, because they don't like us. So
right,
let's kill
they
them.
Don't like us. I see.
I wonder why.
And this is going to make them really love us. Like Connie said, now they will fear you. Yeah, I noticed that the Water Nazi did a really interesting job in this break. But that's okay, because Ponytail is in Broward County and Flores is in Dade. You notice that? She's got our two wonderful live pizza places back to back. Nice going there, Water Nazi. We know you don't make mistakes. We know that. Probably too busy with your OJ blow-up doll back there. 11:52 at 5:60. I have a feeling, I could be wrong, I have a feeling it's a really good thing. We got that noon to one comedy bit hour coming up. Give us a nice respite so we can digest lunch in a relaxed and enjoyable manner.
Yeah.
And you have nothing to fear, by the way, those of you who are concerned about whether I'm going to continue sitting here reading bedtime stories and trying to save the world from itself on this little tiny radio station in Miami. You have nothing to worry about because it's a waste of time, like I've said before. Look at the calls we just got. Just listen to the calls we just got. Where are the rest of the thoughtful people? Where are all of the people who are voting on this poll who are strongly against it, who are concerned about it? Are they calling?
No.
Do they ever call?
No.
No, of course not, because they're all sitting back, which is why politically the country, the pendulum is swinging so far to the right, because everybody else is in la-la land. They stole the election away from you, they stole your government away from you, and you're all back sitting around, and of course, keeping you real busy trying to scrape a few cents together. That helps too. That's part of the game plan. 11:53 at 560 WQM. Hey, you don't have to have a big budget to go to the pizza loft because their prices are incredibly low. Even Jeff Rimmer could afford to take his whole family there and pay for it. He wasn't too happy about it. But you'll be happy because the food is fresh, it's delicious. Every Monday is lasagna night, every Tuesday's eggplant night at the Pizza Loft, at both locations, by the way. Buy one of these dinners on these nights, get the second one for only $5. Every Wednesday, like today, kids eat free with adults, and they can see Jeff's famous magic show. Every Thursday is bike night at the Loft. Come on a motorcycle, buy one dinner, get the second for half price. Fresh, delicious pasta, all cooked to order. Three different kinds of great pizza, the best garlic rolls in the world. They got calzones, they got seafood, chicken, veal, and all kinds of other great Italian dishes that you'll love. You'll find them in the Davie, on University Drive between Griffin and 595. For takeout or delivery there, call 954-916-8880. When you go in there, tell him, you know, Rimmer can't afford it. Please let him in, eat in here for free. We don't want to see a grown man cry. And in Plantation, now the brand new Pizza Loft location, right off the corner of Knob Hill and Sunrise, right behind Walgreens there in that little strip shopping center, 954-382-1999. For takeout, delivery, and catering, 954-382-1999. Don't forget, that's a brand new one. The same great food, the same low prices, the same friendly service, right behind Walgreens, Knob Hill and Sunrise in Plantation.
Live and local, we're Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Well, it be the 12 to 1 hour on WQAM.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I could offer only one tip for the future, act strange and people will leave you alone. The rest of my advice has no basis more reliable than my own meandering experience. Put a slinky around your neck and try to walk downstairs backwards head first. Sit naked in a large bowl of Rice Krispies and sing Feelings while the kernels go snap, crackle, and pop. Go up to a ticket booth and try to stick your head through the hole where they say how much. Lick a stranger. Tell him you're from Bosnia and you're a country, it's a sign of respect. Take lots of pills. One of them might work. Occasionally ask a stranger if they've heard anything from Lewis. Be annoying. During an IRS audit, staple the guy's hand to his desk. Moon a funeral. Play go fetch with a seeing-eye dog while he's working. Run naked through a mall yelling, killer bees, killer bees. Say the word titty without smiling. Try to figure out who said Pauly Shore should star in movies. Don't be surprised if it's the same guy who said John Gacy should work with kids. Ask an old lady if you can carry her groceries, then try to make a run for it. Disappear for great lengths of time. Try to touch your forehead with your tongue. It may not work, but many women will appreciate the effort. At a high school reunion, tell your old English teacher that your dog's still eating your homework. Ask Mark McGuire if he'll take $1 million for one of his balls. Try to find the secret to Carrot Top's success. Understand your conception was an accident, that your parents got wasted and wanted a few more laughs before they passed out. Try not to lose your finger in your nose. Take up Bob Costas and toss him on the lawn next door. Go on a car trip with Bob Costas and force him to stay in his car seat. Try to dribble Bob Costas. Ask all your friends and family for forgiveness. Knowing you, you've done some crap that's really pissed them off. Wish no ill will to anyone, unless you don't like them. Then screw them, they're on their own. Realize anyone who says they're completely happy are completely full of crap. Ask a Hell's Angel if he's a woman, or has he always walked like that. Understand that there are bad people in the world, and you may just be one of them. Sniff an old lady. Imagine Gomer Pyle in a gay bar trying to get lucky. Do this without laughing. Find what's left of your innocence. Understand it, embrace it, protect it, and every so often, take it out for a nice nosh. Care enough not to care. Hum while you eat. Act strange, and people will leave you alone.
Coming up tonight on Inside the Behind, the True Hollywood Celebrity Music Biography Profile Story, we take a good, hard, stiff look into stardom. As America's new patriotism takes hold, what better time to reconsider some British girl who thought she had the right to sing a song about our great country? Yeah, that's right. I'm talking about you, Kim Wilde.
I think it's time we added the name of Kim Wilde to an ever-growing axis of evil.
President George W. Bush lashed out at Kim Wilde in a recent State of the Basic Cable Celebrity Profile address.
There are plenty of fine Americans who could have provided an upbeat but somewhat critical pop tune about our young people. We cannot allow this British import to go unpunished.
The president went on to point out that even the singer's follow-up hit, You Keep Me Hanging On, was a remake
of an American song.
Look, will you people let me go? I mean, set me free, why don't you?
Tonight, Kim Wilde speaks to us from her wire enclosure at Guantanamo Bay, Cuba.
I appeal to the United States to realize that having two lousy hits and then disappearing off the radar, well, it's punishment enough.
Lawyers for the prosecution are prepared to argue that Kim Wilde's music actually punished us back in the 80s. It's a big, juicy, sopping wet look at show business tonight on Inside the Behind.
Shut up, you big hoss! Ginger Rogers takes a mouthful of the sausage in Jorge's pants. That pipe smoker and uncircumcised Cuban engage in a fecular dance. I'm a cranky homophobe. Not that I mind it, but I'm way too old. I fantasize about being in bed in a tryst with Fiedler, my man friend. I'll kiss and make up with Ginger someday. And then ask him to rape my buns over and over again. Though I would not feel remorseful,
no!
And I would not be ashamed about a Ginger and Mo-gay union just boning and stroking away. Boy, Gildy, you're not my type. You sound like a 9-year-old kid.
Hey.
Only a macho manly guy.
You don't notice me.
That makes me flip my wig. If Ginger was a lover of mine, I'd bury my bulbous veiny nose inside his pimply rear end. No, I would not be a sport hole. If I was not a closeted fae, that's why a Ginger and Mo-gay union would make me feel giddy and gay.
Everybody follow my bouncing balls.
Yeah, Ginger and Mo-gay union would make my sore old bony ass feel safe. If we had a Ginger and Mo-gay union, then he wouldn't have to get me raped.
Don't like all the heartburn. Dum dum dum. Every time I see dum 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 that retarded dimwit dum 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 on my TV. He's president dum Republican muscled in an inarticulate idiot. I don't know why they would want this guy, but now he's here. We're screwed the next 4 years with President Thumb.
President Thumb.
Oh, what I'd give to count votes once more and get who we all voted for. Stupid key. Dum, 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 dum. Mindless, drunken, rich kid. Dum, dum, dum. He's even dumber than me.
Yeah.
He's President Dumb. You don't care what it took. You got him in by hook or crook. The Christian right knows what's best. You and I have no fear. We've got a great leader. With President Dumb.
President Dumb.
President Dumb.
I was standing there one day, not thinking I would die.
from being able to make do-do. I should never eat McDonald's. A Big Mac must be trapped inside my bowels. How can you die from infected farts? Who let these butcher doctors in? Now my heart stops. You schmucks at Sinai tore my intestines out. I guess I should have known what to expect living in Miami with the kind of service you get in this town. I would pack and leave tomorrow if I didn't eat that crap I swallowed. Why can't you lend me some chocolate?
I'm dying over here.
Why can't you losers get it right? My bowels were blocked inside my hiney. Can't make my turds go out. Iskatosh, iskatosh. Iskatosh, iskatosh. Iskatosh, iskatosh.
Look at that. He just can't leave. Okay, go to lunch already, will you, please, before we play some really good stuff. It's 8 minutes past noon at 560 QAM. See that nervous laugh? Now, this poster in the Sun Sentinel, the Smallville poster, first of all, it's much ado about nothing. It's like not,
it's,
you know,
nothing.
It's really very bad, and it's like dark and...
It didn't even purdy.
No. And the interesting part of it is, though, you notice Clark is way off to the side, and there's Lana, and way in the back is Lex. Now, is he like doing a Clemenza in this? Looks like he's taking a leak in the field or something, doesn't it? Huh?
Where are his hands?
They're
covered up by the sign there.
Yeah, I mean, far be it for me to be one of the... I mean, he's kind of like looking out of the corner of his eye to make sure she ain't looking, and she's looking like off to the side. Because, you know, you notice in all the episodes, what's that been on, like a year and a half now?
Something like that.
Never touched her, much less kiss.
Wow.
Never a touch, never like a little, you know, on the shoulder, a little anything. Am I right about that?
Maybe he...
Oh, no, I take that back, because when what's-his-name died, when the word came back that... Remember they had the crazy, what was his name, the boyfriend, the blonde kid that went off to...
Oh, I forgot.
Whatever his name
crazy
was.
Crazy kid.
And then he, like, comforted her. He gave her a comforter. But that's it.
Maybe he's afraid he'll hurt her.
Yeah, he sure wasn't afraid of hurting Chloe yesterday. And then, of course, this, she's got to come running in here right when it's getting good. He's got his shirt off, she's rolling around on top of him, and then the little red thing popped out, you know, like, just like that.
The red rock.
The little red rock popped off. Well, he is from outer space. How's the poll coming, Neil? The being freak poll. Let's see. What's your take on war with Iraq? I noticed that some of our people are responding to freerepublic.com, and rightfully so. Nice job. I mean, these people have no life. They sit around. First of all, I could almost understand if they're so politically paranoid that they want to distort the views of the public. But if it's on a CNN poll, an MSNBC poll, something like that, something that, you know, that the public pays any attention to, Time Magazine poll. But Neil Rogers in Miami, who the hell, I mean, what is this is for fun among our listeners? But they're so damn paranoid that even this, we found one here. It's something for them to do, you know, on days when they're not playing golf. 813 votes. What's your take on war with Iraq? All for it. Let's rule. 218. I'm strongly against it. 213. Getting pretty close. All your freepers out there better get busy. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 195. I support it, but I'm nervous about it, 106. Let's take care of North Korea for a 64. And just don't know, 17. I don't know. I do know one thing, boy, all that food. Thanks again to Corky's. That was great, but don't do it again. Oh, man. Have you got any idea the volume of food I consumed in here?
I got an idea. I saw it.
I mean, just ungodly.
Need a lift? Need a ride home?
A lift, not a ride. I need a lift, like with a crane. With a crane. Hey, by the way, guys, size does matter. Not the size of your pupuk we're not talking about. According to the Florida Department of Labor, computer professionals have really big ones. Big, fat, impressive paychecks. According to the state of Florida, computer careers are among the highest paid and in highest demand. A great combination. Fast Train can help you achieve your new high-paying computer career in just 4 short months. They've got locations in Kendall, in Miami, Fort Lauderdale, and Pembroke Pines. With day, evening, and weekend schedules, there's no excuse to stay in your dead-end job and working for crap. Pick up the phone right now and start making a real living. Call 866-FAST-TRAIN toll-free. That's 1-866-FAST-TRAIN. They've got full-time job placement and guaranteed financing, too. Check them out on the web at fasttrain.com or call them this moment instantly. There's no obligation. They'll explain it to you. 1-866-FAST-TRAIN because you can have a really big paycheck, too. With a computer career from our friends at FAST-TRAIN.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560 QAM.
ape is funny.
Well, congratulations. Get a life.
Did you see our ratings for the last book?
Yeah, I know whose fault that is.
Sure. Couldn't possibly be us.
Watch your back, or you won't wait for more. No, mo, no, mo, no, mo, no, mo. Watch your back, or you won't wait for more. No, more.
I got enough I gotta think about on top of getting raped in, and I don't need a rating that's a minus 8.
Don't care what you do, long as it's understood. You gotta work a little harder on the guest you book.
Or else you gots to go. There's a lot of fat producers, you know.
That's right.
Watch your back, Zach, or you won't wait for more. No, mo, no, mo, no, mo, no, mo. Watch your back, Zach, or you won't wait for more. No, mo.
Oh, brother, all that blubber, I don't understand. You can eat from a trough while using both hands.
You big fat fat, you made a ratings fool. You just like Clinton, it's all your fault.
Better straighten your fat ass out.
Or we'll take the food out of your mouth.
That's right, watch your back, Zach. Or you won't wait for more, no more, no more, no more, no more. Watch your back, Zach. Or you won't wait for more, no more.
Listen what we say!
Watch your back, Zach. Or you won't wait for more, no more, no more, no more, no more. Watch your back, Zach. Or you won't wait for more, no more. You know who I am? You're lucky you got a job here. Try that one more time and you're all fired!
You love Shakira's top 10 hit, Underneath Your Clothes. Shakira sings other people's hits. She already made music history by recording her first English language album. And now she's taking her art form to the next level by re-recording songs that were already hits in English. Only this time they're in English again. Shakira sings other people's hits. Shakira sings other people's hits.
Just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
If you really, really like Shakira's CD, Laundry Service, then you'll really, really, really like her new CD. Shakira sings other people's hits. No tenemos en español en estos momentos.
Squirt, squirt.
Wait up, little Georgie, wait up. Chill out, little Georgie, chill out. The people have been polled, and this is what you've been told. By 2-1, they don't want war, so put your plans on hold. Wait up, little Georgie. Hold up, little Georgie. Well, why don't we try to get Osama? Why don't we get Mullah Omar?
Yes.
What we gonna tell the world when they say no more war? Wake up, little Georgie. Hold up, little Georgie. Well, we know Saddam is really a big threat, but no one wants to see World War III yet. Wait up a little. Georgie. Chill out, little Georgie. We ought to stay home. Wait up, little Georgie, wait up. Chill out, little Georgie, chill out. Before you send our men, be sure to count to ten. Before you blow the crap out of Iraq, please listen to the UN. Wait up, little Georgie. Hold up, little Georgie. Wait up, little Georgie. Chill out, little Georgie. She talks to guys with lousy diction.
Hey, honey, can I buy you a drink?
Vinny Guido Joey D.
Hey, Joey D, that's me, yeah.
He asks her, do you come here often?
What's a babe like you doing in a balls-up joint like this?
Can I get you a drink on me?
Hey, don't mind the sore on my lip. It's temporary, you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah, don't go away. You know, you're beautiful, babe. I like that fishnet skirt. That's beautiful. You remind me of my mother.
Bloodshot eyes. He got to pee now.
Be right back, sweetie. Just gonna drain the drink.
Wears his chinos way too tight.
Oh, yeah. But don't I look good?
Breaks out a wad of 50s when the check comes.
Yeah, I'm in the union.
Then expects her to spend the night.
What do you mean, no? What do you mean?
Yes, she talks to Guido.
Come on, honey.
They all wear fancy gold chains.
Come on, sweetie, I'll show you a good time.
Oh, yes, she talks to Guido.
Come on, baby.
All looks and no brains.
What do you mean, no brains? Who said that? Hey.
Yes, she talks
Come
to
here.
Guido.
Come here. Let's fight.
But
hey.
She's wise to their
games. Hey, where are you?
Oh, yes, she talks
where
to Guido. She's always entertained.
Hey, honey, where you going? Come back, sweetheart. Hey, come here, sweetie. Come back, honey.
This is former Vice President of the United States, Al Gore. I have recently poked my head out of the shadows of oblivion to take pot shots at the president. I have reappeared, much like Punxsutawney Phil, the groundhog creature that reappears each year to determine whether or not we'll have an early spring. I wish it to be known that it was I who was responsible for saving the lives of those 9 miners in Pennsylvania over the weekend. I had asked the media to keep my name out of it as not to appear a spotlight hog. However, I feel the American people have a right to know the truth. Here's what happened. Upon hearing of this unfortunate accident, I raced to the scene. I lowered myself into the mine using an old Ron Popeil pocket fisherman and some baling wire. Down, 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 into the depths of darkness I sank, never thinking of my own safety, but rather of the safety of those men on the ground. When I reached the miners, they said to me, "Hey, you're the guy that invented the Internet, right?" I said, "Yes." We all had a Mike's Hard Lemonade, which I brought with me down into the hole, and then we sat around and reenacted the fart scene from Blazing Saddles. I thought you should know the truth. And now, much like the groundhog creature Punxsutawney Phil, I'll sink back into the darkness of oblivion until I am needed again. This is Al Gore, superhero.
Meet Joe. He's rich. He's handsome. He has great taste in furniture. And he has 20 beautiful women interested in him. But there's a twist. He's not interested in them. It's Joe Homosexual, Fox's newest reality romance show. See what happens when these lovely ladies try to get Joe to switch teams.
But he didn't want to talk to me at all. He just wanted to see more pictures of my brother.
Don't miss Joe Homosexual.
We were supposed to have a romantic dinner together alone, but I didn't know he was also bringing Cliff, his friend.
And be sure to catch the final episode of Joe Homosexual when Joe pops the big question.
Sandra?
Yes, Joe?
Would you...
Leave me and Cliff alone for a few minutes.
Whatever.
Joe Homosexual, right after Boston Public Bathhouse, only on Fox.
This weekend, North Korea, Iraq, Libya, Syria. It's the Weapons of Mass Destruction World Tour.
World Tour.
Coming to the Botulitis Coliseum.
Only the strong survive.
Saturday, see Randy Rason, Cyanide Sam, and The Undertaker. Annihilate the Axis of Evil in a steel cage dead lumberjack match. Also scheduled to appear, Cholera, Hoof and Mouth, and Stone Dead Steve Austin.
Unleash the power.
Can you smell what Steve Saren is cooking?
Then Sunday!
The crowd will shake.
The world will quake.
With the atomic thunder of Andy Anthrax, Big Al Qaeda, Mean Mr. Mustard, and Goldberg in the World Heavyweight Title Match. Feel the sting of a sore loser in the Smallpox Battle Royale.
There is no vaccine.
When you catch the beaver of contagious hand-to-hand mortal combat, the Weapons of Mass Destruction World Tour.
World Tour.
This weekend
at the Botulitis Coliseum.
1225 at 560. Don't step on me again. At 560 WQM, I think Hank's going to get food from Corky's today, too. I just have that feeling. Because evidently you heard me yesterday jonesing for it, and so they decided probably it would appear they're going to send some to everybody. Huh?
Just to cover their bases.
Why not spread it around a little bit? The offer could use another meal. Not too much now, okay? Don't be gorging with those potato pancakes and that kishki and those delicious Reuben sandwiches like the half of one I had. I had enough food for four people easily today, and I didn't want any. I was just, wanted a little brisket, a little taste.
Just enough to wet your beak?
Enough to wet my beak. 913 votes on the poll. Thanks so much, all you freepers out there, your freerepublic.com, your very intense people, for helping to fund our gay agenda on this program. Helping to fund all of our liberal causes, okay? 913 votes. What's your take on the war with Iraq? I'm strongly against it. 256. All for it. Let's roll. Just changed again. Wait a minute. Let's see. I'm strong against it. 257 out of 918. All for it. Let's roll. 253. Haven't been convinced yet that it's justified. 213. I support it, but I'm nervous about it. 110. Let's take care of North Korea first. 66. And I just don't know. 19 people said that. Speaking of not knowing, have you ever been presented with an opportunity when you should have, could have, or would have done something, but you just didn't do it, you couldn't pull the trigger, so to speak? Well, here's an incredible Fannie Mae mortgage rate waiting for you out there at just 3.45%. This rate is available by calling Financial Group toll-free at 1-800-940-5363. If you were to compare a 7% rate with 3.45%, you'd save $3,500 in the first year loan for each $100,000 you owe. $100,000 cost you only $447 a month. Here's an opportunity that won't last because it's a 40-year low. So if you're really thinking about refinancing or purchasing a home, here's the smart thing to do. Get the information. There's no obligation. Call Financial Group and they'll tell you how this works. Call 1-800-940-5363. The process is simple, and like I said, the call is free, 1-800-940-LEND. Financial Group has been an equal housing lender to thousands of borrowers with this Fannie Mae program, and they can do the same for you. Credit restrictions do apply, and rates are subject to change if you wait too long, 5.34 APR. Call Financial Group today, 1-800-940-LEND.
Live and local, this is Sports Radio 560, QAQAM.
If I am guilty of anything, it is of giving all that I have, to give.
My penis, my buttocks, my lower torso, thighs, and any other area that they wanted
to help children all over the world.
Good morning, Sony Music.
Tommy Mottola, please.
Master's calling.
Is the king of pop.
Come again?
No, thank you.
And this is in regards to...
It's a personal matter. Ow.
Please hold.
Hello.
Hello, it's Michael.
Who, the track kid?
No, that's Michael Johnson.
Oh, the basketball guy?
No, that's Michael Jordan.
But who is this?
I am going to protest you and your devil-like qualities with my fans.
Hey, newsflash, freak boy, you don't have any fans. Otherwise, they would have bought that horrible record you handed me.
Ow. Come on. Can you feel that? How about that?
What are you talking about, Tinkerbell?
I have a Timmy Motorola voodoo doll, and I'm sticking pins in your marble bag area.
Hey, sicko!
Ooh, do you feel that? Don't lie.
Listen, head case, are we done here?
You have to let me out of my contract,
no.
Please.
No.
But I really need to. I'll be there.
No! Oh, here we go with the singing.
I'll be there.
Yeah, you'll be there. You be where you gotta be, kid, okay? I got lunch with Chuck Mangione. I love that funny hat he wears. Hey, adios, Fruit Loops. My best of bubbles, you wackadoo.
Can you feel that? Come on.
Del Frico and Debbie Rowe got married down under. Did they make hot monkey love? Can't help but wonder, talking about Wacko,
Jacko,
Michael got wet, making love to Debbie Rowe with a llama in their bed. Debbie's been injected with the seed from Michael's loin. When the baby pops right out, he'll have a glove's hand on his groin. That's because Wacko,
Jacko,
Michael has sex. Debbie says she'll be his wife, just keep writing those checks.
You are to be happy and to be feeling carefree, because President Saddam Hussein has defeated the infidel Clinton and the satanic America while causing great embarrassment to the covetous and inflicting great pain on our enemies during the recent UN inspection standoff. This is why, my fellow Iraqi citizens, Baghdad McDonald's is to be celebrating most strenuously this weekend. Yes, automatic weapons have to be fired into the air without regard for human safety as you enter the Baghdad McDonald's. Bring what remains of your family to be meeting Ronald Mohammed at the door.
Do not be forgetting, at noon today, I am to be chopping off the hands of the hamburger.
You are to be sending the fruit of your loins to play in the kitty bunker as you choose from a most tempting menu that includes Big Macs with secret scud sauce, Fish McBoom sandwiches, Quarter Pounder with fuse, not to be forgetting our famous flies. Yes, my fellow Iraqi citizens, we are to be celebrating our wondrous leader Saddam Hussein's victory over the soulless ones of the United Nations. And eat this weekend at the Baghdad McDonald's.
A portion of proceeds will be given to our great leader Saddam Hussein's most secretive researching program to be building weapons of mass destruction.
No, Saddam's hiding a lot more than guns.
Yes.
They say they're weapons of mass destruction. I say we send a couple megatons. Bomb Iraq. In the Gulf War, we let him off the hook. I think it's time to give his butt a whoop. So it's time to load those B-1s up. Bomb Iraq.
All right.
Bomb Iraq. Till there's nothing left to see. Bomb Iraq. Till Saturn's 6 feet deep. Bomb Iraq. Blow up the creed. Bomb Iraq.
And they say he's got some germs and chemicals that burn, and then he might load them up on scuds. If we land prepared, we better beware, because some of them scouts won't be dead.
Bomb Iraq. Bring it to an end. Bomb Iraq. Blow him up again. Bomb Iraq. Live on CNN. Bomb Iraq. Bomb Iraq.
Toss this stupid bomb.
Bomb Iraq.
this one to let all you people know how us stoners feel. You know, real high. Can you pass the brownies? Look at that pot so glorious. At the age of 9 I was curious, so I asked my mom for some cannabis to smoke before school on the bus. Got my friends to love the pot. Every day, every night, we just can't stop. One day we even toked up with a cop. Smoking a big fat hookah. Say I plant my seeds, seeds, seeds for my weed, weed, weed. When shit, we're free, free, free. Gonna roll it again. Say I plant my seeds, seeds, seeds for my weed, weed, weed for my bong. Let me smoke that bong.
Get
out. Baby. That bong, ba bong, bong, bong. I love it when I smoke the bong. Just like Cheech and Chong. Yeah, yeah. That bong, ba bong, bong, bong. Look at that pot so glorious. At the age of 9 I was curious, so I asked my mom for some cannabis. Used to smoke before school on the bus. Got my friends to love the pot. Every day in and out, we just can't stop. One day we even toked up with a cop. Smoking a big fat hookah. Say I plant my seeds, seeds, seeds for my weed, weed, weed. When shit, we're free, free, free. Gonna roll it again. Say I plant my seeds, seeds, seeds for my weed, weed, weed for my bong. Let me smoke that bong. Baby. That bong, ba bong, bong, bong. I love it when I smoke the bong. Just like Cheech and Chong. Yeah, yeah. That bong, ba bong, bong, bong. Hey, Jimmy, man. Yeah, yeah, pass that right over here.
Now, you know, when the beast loses the rest of the weight, gets down to a spelt 180 or whatever it's going to be, there are going to be some people in this building say, you know, I liked him better when he was fat. You know that somebody's going to say that, don't you?
Somebody will.
There are always assholes who say things like that. I liked so-and-so better when they were fat. Yeah, Fat Boy will say that. Josh Friedman will say that. Anybody else? 20 till 1 at 560 WQM. How's that poll coming? The Freepers are back again, baby. They're on it. And thank you so much for your assistance to our homosexual left-wing agenda. What's your take on war with Iraq? 964 votes. Shocking. All for it. Let's roll. 270. Strongly against it. 269. Haven't been convinced it's justified. 223. I support it, but I'm nervous about it. 113. Let's take care of North Korea first. 68. And 21 people from the Greg Reed School of Life say,
yeah.
Don't know. Don't know. I'll tell you one thing, if your life is turning to crap because you don't feel good when you get out of the sack in the morning, probably because your mattress is a piece of crap. It's lumpy, it's bumpy. Maybe it wasn't all so great in the first place. If you get you a great new name brand mattress from Dollar Mattress, one thing you can be sure of is you're going to get a great night's sleep night after night and feel super when you hop out of the sack in the morning. They carry all the top names. They got Sealy, Serta, Simmons, King Coil, every size and style. And the best part of the deal is when it comes to price, delivery, and 30-day in-home thing. What do you call it? An in-home thing.
Well, I don't know what you call
comfort
it.
Comfort guarantee. In other words, you get a chance to sleep on it for up to 30 days. Hey, listen, my blood sugar is 920. You ought to be real kissing the ground that I can actually speak in here right now. That's 2 days this week. Right through the freaking roof, baby. I think it's a conspiracy. I think Moe done it. Anyway, here's the deal. Call Dollar Mattress toll-free at 1-800-MATTRESS. Pick out exactly the kind of mattress you like, and they'll be there in no time, knocking in your door, taking away the crappy old bedding, and setting up your great new one. Like I said, you got 30-day comfort exchange period to make sure it's the right mattress for you and your back. They show up when you want them. You got any day, 7 days a week, that kind of delivery when you want to be there. Any two-hour window, noon to two, one to three, etc. And everyday low prices that are absolutely unbeatable in those expensive, overpriced bedding and department stores. Call them right now. You'll be sleeping like a child tonight. 1-800-MATTRESS. Mattress, 1-800-MATTRES.
Live and local, this is 560.
The radio's all yours now.
QAM.
It's G. Gordon Liddy, and they don't come any worse than Neil Rogers.
I got warts, they're multiplying. When you stand up with all those things down there, can't see a heart I'm hanging on you.
Can't see a heart.
genital warts. Ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugly genital warts. Ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugly genital warts. Ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugly genital warts. Ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. From my thighs to my knees, I've got disease. Genital warts. Ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugly
genital warts, ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Ugly genital warts, ugly, ugly, ugly warts. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yeah, come on, all you big strong men. Uncle Sam needs your help again. There's a guy who's kind of a pain. He goes by the name of Saddam Hussein. We'll shoot him dead and put him in the soil, and then we're gonna take his oil. And it's one, two, three. What are we fighting for? Don't ask me, I don't give a crap. Next stop is Old Iraq. And it's 5, 6, 7. Fire up the F-16. Yeah, we'll blow it all up and in no time. We'll put up an Exxon sign. We'll do it, George, and you'll be glad. I hope you do it better than your dad. Gotta go see if that guy Saddam has really got himself an atomic bomb. You know we'll never make peace with this creep. The UN can take a flying leap. And it's 1, 2, 3. What are we fighting for? Pretty soon the whole Middle East will be a spot of grease. And it's 5, 6, 7. Here comes the apocalypse. Well, 2 world wars didn't do much harm. Maybe the 3rd time's a charm. And it's 1, 2, 3. What are we fighting for? Don't ask me, I don't give a crap. Next time.
Badass Rosie, please go away. Find a new way to attack a buffet. Go home and eat your ho-hos till you explode. Just like your fat, fat churning ladies have to buy 2 seats on a plane. Spilling your fingers that have yellow stain from Cheetos. Can't see your toes. Pastor Piggy, who knows? Proud to be fat, disgusting, and pasty. Oi! You make the shut-in women smile. They like a gal who's fat and sassy. Big, smelly, fat, so repulsive and vile. Your body cheese smells like a cracker. After it was occupied by Ed Asner. Need a shoehorn to get into your car. Cause you're too goddamn wide. Oink and squeal, oink and squeal, oink and squeal, fat lady. Living with your lover lesbian. Slobbering and snorting a tree between her knees. Mashed potato yeast. Smells fishy to me. Lapping up a tuna that's moist and tasty. Hey!
He ain't revealing a thing. Emphatically he denies. He was renting his mind.
10 to 1 at 560 WQM. Another year's come and gone, and a lot of folks out there made New Year's resolutions. For example, like putting your house back in order, making it look like respectable, especially after all those holidays. Here's the answer to help you. Dry Concepts. I've been using my house for over 20 years, and I guarantee you, nobody in the world does the job that they do for you. They give you a written, guaranteed price before they start, and when they finish, you look around and you think a miracle worker's been in your house. And guess what? They have. because they're the only ones in the world who dry clean your carpets. It's an exclusive patented method, and when they get done, because they get out even the deepest dirt in the fibers of your carpet, they look just like brand new. They smell lemony fresh, they dry in a few hours, and like I said, you'll always be amazed at how great they look. So whether it's time to clean your carpeting, your upholstery, leather furniture, whether you want to get rid of pet odors or mildew odors from water damage, no problem. Dry Concepts is here for you. Call them toll-free from anywhere, 1-800-248-5071. 1-800-248-5071, or you can check out more about the amazing things they do for you on their website, dryconcepts.com. Dry Concepts, clean today, entertain tonight. Not just a slogan, it's their business at Dry Concepts.
We're Sports Radio 560, QAM.
Go back to Canada, you Jew bastard.
So Canada's our home and native grass.
Oh!
High walls and sea will knock you on your ass.
Yeah.
With the shot-eyes munching by our side, we reclaimed your gold, you see. It's a legal drug according to
every 10 minutes I gotta empty this goddamn bag. Hey, who the hell are you?
My name is Carlos.
Well, get your ass out of that sink. I gotta wash these H spots off my head.
Okay, I promise I will.
What are you doing in there anyway?
I am washing my balls.
Well, get out of there now.
Okay, I promise I will.
Oh, wait something.
Yes?
I kind of like the way your balls are floating there. All that hardware in your face, kind of is sexy.
Gracias.
I like that bone in your nose. Here, let me touch
it. No, you are a very bad man. You're not my type.
I'll give you a dollar.
Okay.
Yeah. Say, let me give you a hand washing your balls.
No, leave me alone. I will not be your bitch.
Come on, pal, trust me. You'll get used to it.
Please, I have no phone, father car, not a single luxury.
I'll give you another dollar.
Okay.
To the floor.
Yeah, ow!
What do you got down there? Some kind of meat grinder?
I promise I will.
Oh, I can't get out.
I pierced my hole, too.
Yeah!
Trump 59560 WQMR poll, 1,009 votes.
Oh!
Shocking, amazing, and I bet you at least 20 or 30 of them are real, too. What's your take on the war with Iraq? I'm strongly against it, 279. All for it, let's roll, 276. You see that? You following that?
I follow.
Keep your eye on the bouncing votes. Haven't been convinced it's justified, 240. I support it, but I'm really nervous about it, 123. Let's take care of North Korea first, 70.
Oh!
And don't know, 21. 21 diddlers out there just standing there. They don't know.
What?
Well, no matter what the question is, they just don't freaking know. You know?
No, I don't know.
I don't either. Anyway, I do know the lineup, which I haven't given all day today. Maybe it's because my blood sugar was 850 or something like that. We got the Mad Dog coming up next. He's sitting by in the other room. We got the Humper. Hank Goldberg will be in the studio 3 to 7. And I'm sure that Corky's going to bring in the Humper food if they know what's good for him. You know what I'm saying? He gets really surly if you don't get his food a lot, often. 7 o'clock, we got Chitko Panther preview. The Panthers and the Toronto Maple Leafs. At the arena, 7:30 tonight. Then we got Eddie K after the hockey game from GA and Joe and Mark overnight. And in closing, only one thing to say, and it is go, Leafs, go.
Bye, bye, bye!
The Neil Rogers Show on 560 WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Cunnilingus and psychiatry brought us to this.